All right, Jim, we will be coming your way in 35.
Your home for local sports is Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. Welcome to Sports Radio 1350's High School Football Game of the Week, presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine, the official healthcare and sports medicine provider of the York Revolution.
Henry has it, turns the corner, he's inside the five, he's at the goal line, he's into the end zone, Andrew Henry, 7-yard touchdown run, would not be denied.
High School Football plays here on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports, and bringing you the best of the York Adams League every Friday night.
Campbell to throw, fires it, he has Terry Keynes. Keynes is into the backfield at the 20, tripped up at the 15, still going, he's into the end zone.
Now let's head out to the stadium. With the call of tonight's game, here's Ron Ruben.
And good evening and welcome to Week 8 of York Adams League High School Football. Tonight a big Division 3 matchup as the Fighting Irish of York Catholic host the Eagles of Bermudian Spring. Kind of a damp evening here, 58 degrees. It's cloudy, but it hasn't rained for a couple of hours, so we are going to hope that that continues at least most of the way through the evening. It's a natural grass field, so that could be a factor tonight for these teams. Both teams 4-0 in the division, both teams 6-1 overall. So, Gareth, this is a huge game, both for the division as the district standings. The Irish are by a couple hundreds of a point in the number one spot in Double A. Only two teams make it. Bermudian currently has two spot in Triple A, where four teams will go. So this is big, both in the league and the districts.
As mentioned, both these teams talented squads. Head coaches are great. Eric DePew with York Catholic, John Defoe, the most tenured coach in the division with Bermudian Springs, and both these teams come in here with only one loss. Bermudian Springs lost to a good Shippensburg Greyhounds team, and York Catholic, their only blemish on the schedule is Burke's Catholic. It was a very team. Catholic beat York Catholic 34-0, and it was a 28-24 loss for Bermudian against Shippensburg. So good tests throughout the year, played some talented squads, and they've come away almost with undefeated records, but both teams coming here tonight looking to keep that season going as they continue to write the narrative.
Absolutely. Wind kicking up a little bit here. This is the High School Football Game of the Week presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine and the Flying Feet pregame show on 1350 in game time. And you know, the Irish have proven they can move it through the air as well as on the ground. Jakar Kennard, a talented runner. Daniel Kemick will run it and throw it. And Riley Brennan had a huge game last week. I think almost 200 yards was for the Irish against Biglerville. And Bermudian, on the other hand, is more of a running team, although, you know, they can throw it a bit too. Chase Dahl, sophomore quarterback, has 542 yards through the air.
Right, and that number one target through the air is running back Devin Hogden. And Bermudian comes in running that wing T. Always difficult when you're able to throw it successfully to running backs out of the backfield. It makes some matchup difficulties for any defense. So that could be a huge key tonight for this York Catholic defense.
All right, Ron Room and Gareth Hissong with you at York Catholic, the Irish and the Eagles of Bermudian Springs in the High School Football Game of the Week presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine and our Flying Feet pregame show. Take a break now. Come back with the coach's interview from Media One after this.
Cheerleading takes on many different forms across many different age groups. In other words,
this is not your mother's cheerleading squad.
Flying Feet.
Today, cheering means youth pep squad, high school and college sideline squad, competition stunting squads, gymnastic tumbling squad, and every type of squad calls for different types of equipment. But no matter what they're cheering for, Flying Feet Sports Shoes has it. Flying Feet has been outfitting cheerleading programs throughout Central PA and Northern Maryland since 1982. They specialize in cheerleading shoes from Asics, Infinity, Kappa, and more, including a large inventory of cheer briefs and boycott shorts, bodysuits, and crop tops in all the right colors. Socks, warm-ups, carry bags, rain jackets, megaphones, pom-poms, Flying Feet has them all with prices that meet or beat internet suppliers. And because they're in stock, you can try them on.
Try doing that with your mouth.
Individuals, small squads, entire teams, no matter what you're cheering for,
Flying Feet.
1511 Mount Rose Avenue, New York, a half mile west of exit 18 off I-83.
PA.com is your home for local high school sports. Log on for all the scores, stats, photos, and more, plus live stream coverage of the area's can't-miss matchups all season long. Stay in the game no matter where you are with the free Game Time PA app. Download it directly to your iPhone or Android and get all the Game Time features you love when you're on the go. Available at the iPhone App Store, Android Market, and, of course, GameTimePA.com.
Serving York County for 60 years, Jim's Auto Repair is your Napa Auto Care Center. Built on prompt, honest, and guaranteed service, Jim's Auto Repair does it all. Oil changes, state inspections, and tune-ups to helping your car last longer with regular maintenance. Schedule your appointment online at jimsautoyork.com or call 848-2749. That's 848-2749. Jim's Auto Repair, your key to great service. 108 East 11th Avenue, York.
Mornings at 9, Dan Patrick on Sports Radio 1350, WOIK.
Welcome back to our Flying Feet pregame show. Tonight's contest, we feature Bermudian Springs at York Catholic. Joining me on our Media One Coach's interviews is head coach of York Catholic, Coach Eric DePue. Now Coach, your offense is moving the ball well, averaging 26 points a game. What's your plan on offense tonight?
A little bit the same. We want to try to establish a run to open up our pass game. Go from there. I think sort of a good mix. I think, some receivers really stepped up to kind of help us out in that area. Kennedy doing a great job at 206 yards last week. So it's more or less what you see from us. Establish the run and then throw the ball.
And Danny Yokemic and Jakar Kennard are two experienced and versatile players for you on offense. Are they your key leaders?
Oh, they're captains. Yeah, they're captains. I mean, they're guys that been here. I mean, Dan will be a four-year starter for us. So definitely they're playmakers. They're just, great young men, and they always lead by example.
Bermudian has almost 2,000 yards on the ground this season, and Devin Hogden has been explosive at runner and receiver. What's your key on defense tonight?
Stop the run. We got to stop the run. We got to be, our assignments. Got to read our keys. Got to tackle. Got to tackle well. We can't be tackling high. And they do a traditional wing key. They do a nice job, setting everything up. We just got to be try to force some second and longs, third and long situations, and just get guys to the ball.
Coach of York Catholic, Eric, a win tonight puts you in the driver's seat for the division title and in a good spot to get into districts. What will you tell your players in the locker room about the importance of tonight's game?
We kind of talked about it at our pregame meal. I mean, this a win here, keeps you at the top of the division. Of course, there's still two games to go, but a win here tonight will probably lock us in the district, our fourth straight district title appearance. So, it's just a matter of how bad you want it. We've been here twice with them before, a couple years ago, same scenario, both undefeated in division. We came up short last year. If we would have took that win, we'd at least been co-champions. But we just got to get over the hump here and leave it all on the field tonight.
Coach, I'm excited to see some Irish football tonight. It's been good catching up with you. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Our coach's interview is brought to you by Media One. Stay tuned for more of our pregame coverage after this.
Sports injury? Walk into WellSpan Urgent Orthopedics for immediate care. No appointment is ever needed. Our orthopedic and sports medicine specialists are here to treat you. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today for hours at our York and Hanover locations.
GameTimePA.com is your home for local high school sports. Log on for all the scores, stats, photos, and more, plus live stream coverage of the area's can't-miss matchups all season long. Stay in the game no matter where you are with the free GameTimePA app. Download it directly to your iPhone or Android and get all the game time features you love when you're on the go. Available at the iPhone App Store, Android Market, and, of course, GameTimePA.com.
Beer and Soda Mart is your home for a wide variety of soda and snacks. Now under new ownership, Beer and Soda Mart is owned and operated by Daniel and Laura Curie and has a friendly and knowledgeable staff there to assist you. Also your one-stop shop for lottery tickets and gift cards. Be sure to like us on Facebook for specials and monthly giveaways. Stop by Beer and Soda Mart or call us at 246-2944. Beer and Soda Mart, just off Route 74 in the Dairyland Square Shopping Center in Redline.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Welcome back to our Flying Feet pregame show. Tonight's contest, Bermudian Springs visiting York Catholic. Joining us, our Media One coach interviews is head coach of Bermudian Springs, Coach John Defoe. Devin Hogden has had some big games for you this year. You have four running backs who have combined for about 1,700 yards rushing. What do you need in offense to be successful tonight?
You do the things we've been doing lately. First and foremost, take care of the ball. You know, and then secondly, we've got to, you know, we got to hold our end of the line of scrimmage. They got some really big guys up front, so we got to give our backs an opportunity, give them a little space to do what they can. We've had a nice luxury. We got four or five kids that we believe can make plays in the backfield. And that gives us the ability to change if, you know, one's not having a great night or something like that.
Chase Dahl, your quarterback, is a sophomore. How are you preparing him for a big game without rattling his nerves too much?
Chase's pretty even keel. I don't worry with Chase. He knows what's expected. He was with us freshman last year until he got hurt. I just always, what I stress, I could just, you know, this is why we play, this is why you put all the practice. It's going to have fun, you know, let your instincts and your natural abilities lead you. You know, you don't need to worry about the rest of that stuff.
He is John Defoe, head coach of Meridian Springs. York Catholic has a diverse offense with several guys who could hurt you. What's the Eagles' key on defense tonight?
We just got to be sound. We got to tackle real well, and we got to keep things in front of us, not give up the big plays. You know, they're going to hit some plays. When they do, we got to hold them to, you know, 10, 12, 15 yard in the games, not let them go for 60 and 70 yard touchdowns. And, I really think that's a big key. And then, of course, just tackle. You got to tackle well. Plays got to end when you get there.
A win tonight puts you in the driver's seat for the division title and keeps you at the head for the district playoff spot. What have you talked to your players about concerning the importance of this game?
Our guys know what's at stake, so we don't spend a lot of time talking about that. I just really talked about what were your goals at the beginning of the season. It was disappointing last year in Week 10 to watch a game-winning 36-yard field goal, you know, take our league championship away, and these guys' goal was to win that back. So, tonight's a huge step towards that goal. But the reality is they all count as one. We still have some games after this. But I think they understand the reality that after tonight, who York Catholic plays in the last 2 weeks and, you know, what's at stake.
Coach, it was nice catching up with you. Best of luck tonight.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Our coach's interview is brought to you by Media One. And stay tuned for tonight's contest for Bermudian Springs at York Catholic.
Hunter's Hill Orthodontics is a longtime staple in the orthodontic care community. With offices in York and Dillsburg, our practice's top priority is to provide you with the highest quality orthodontic care in a friendly, comfortable environment. Call our York offices, 1910 Kenneth Road, at 767-6694 to make your appointment, or at 1399 South Queen Street, 885-5468. Or in Dillsburg, call 502-1186. We've got your smile at Hunter's Hill Orthodontics. Unique Physique is your neighborhood gym in York. Young or old, it's the fitness center for you. Unique Physique has special classes for senior citizens like Zumba, chair yoga, and Silver and Fit Explore. Seniors, if your insurance has a Silver Sneakers or Silver and Fit plan, you can get a free membership at Unique Physique and two sessions with a trainer, also free. Achieve greater control of your health with physical activity and regular exercise. If you're looking for greater independent life, call John Kirchner at 755-2639.
If you're buying new flooring, besides clicking around the internet, you need to see Wecker's Flooring Center. You'll be excited by Wecker's new design center for luxury vinyl tile. Wecker's expanded hardwood and laminate departments will impress you. And Wecker's variety of carpeting and warehouse truckload buys on remnants and rolls is unmatched. But the reason to choose Wecker's is trust, from the buying experience to the installation. That's why they're voted best 11 years running. Wecker's Flooring Center, Route 30, Hallam Exit.
There's only one place for local high school sports. Sports Radio 1350.
And we're back here at your Catholic High School. Ron Room and Gareth Hissong with you on the Flying Feet pregame show and the high school football game of the week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine, the Catholic Fighting Irish marching band entertaining the crowd here as we get ready for a big one in Division III, York Catholic and Bermudian Springs. Time now for our Huntersville Ortho look around the league. Another game tonight, Division I, Red Lion at Central. Lions are rolling unbeaten. Central still hanging around though with just one league loss.
To win this game, Central has to stop the prolific running attack of the Lions. If they can do that, they might have a chance to win.
All right, Dallastown and New Oxford. Wildcats just one loss. New Oxford still looking for their first win.
This will be a good game for the Wildcats of Dallastown to work their craft and polish things up.
All right, and they're getting ready. Next week we'll be at Dallastown as Dallastown hosts Central, so that'll be a big one in D1. Spring Grove and Northeastern, a big game for both of these teams, both 2-2 in the league. Northeastern 5-2 overall, the Rockets at 4-3.
Northeastern, the Bobcats are the favorite in this game. Spring Grove needs to stop the big play if they're going to be successful.
And York High still looking for their first win. They're on the road in the Mustang Corral tonight. Mustangs 2-2 in the league. They want to stay in any kind of contention for that or a district spot. They're both long shots. They got to win tonight.
Mustang Corral is a tough place to play. York High does not come out with a win tonight.
All right, Division 2 now. Kennerdale's at Eastern. The Rams still looking for their first win. Eastern 3-1. They're sitting atop Division 2 right now.
Eastern's had some good wins this year. They're going to continue to roll over the Rams at Kennerdale tonight.
A couple teams struggling a little bit right now. Susquehannock at West York. Bulldogs are 1-6 and 1-2. Warriors are 2-5, also 1-2 in the league.
This is an interesting matchup. Battle of the Beatons. See what team can come out on top.
All right, and Suburban at Dover. This is a big one in Division. Not so much in Division 2. Suburban's 3-0, so they're in pretty good shape. They're 5-2 overall. The Eagles just 2-5, but they can play tough.
We saw Suburban earlier this year. They didn't look too good in that ball game against Northeastern, but they've turned things up as of late. I think they come out with a win against Dover.
All right. Division 3 now. The other games tonight. Biglerville's at Littlestown. The Canners 0-7. Littlestown 6-1. They're only lost to these Irish of York Catholic.
Yeah, Biglerville got roughed up last week from the Irish here at York Catholic. Littlestown will roll over the Canners tonight.
All right, Bolts have Bermudian next week, so if the Bolts win tonight and win next week, they could be in the driver's seat, or at least for a tie. Fairfield at DeLone. Both these teams are 4-3, 1-3 in the league.
DeLone's a favorite. My sister-in-law is back there tonight, well, celebrating then some reunion with cheerleaders. She gets to do her little routine tonight. I think they come out on top.
Absolutely.
Because of that spirit.
That'll do it. And Hanover at York Tech. This is an interesting game. The Nighthawks 3-4. They started off 2-0, have struggled since, and the York Tech Spartans are 4-3, and they're 2-2 in the league.
Yeah, I mean, just talked about the recent matchup, Fairfield at DeLone. Don't sleep on Fairfield. Same thing for Hanover at York Tech. Don't sleep on York Tech. Hanover has to come in, do their fundamentals, play their game if they're going to be successful.
All right, that's our look around the league brought to you by Huntersville Ortho. So we get ready for York Catholic and Bermudian. Starting lineups from Trish Hauser are next. And we'll have that for you after this message on Sports Radio 1350 and GameTimePA.com.
Broadway Transmission? I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they quit.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, and don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our Atra certified technicians. Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they helped me with financing. With my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA card and saved some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
Today, it seems everybody is offering a discount on car insurance.
insurance, but at what price? Reduce protection and personal service. At State Farm, you can earn discounts and still get full service and dependable protection. From the world's largest car insurer, see me, Trish Hauser, 1865 Susquehanna Trail North, York. For the State Farm Multiple Line Discount. With State Farm, you get an agent you can depend on and an insurance company you can trust. For the details on State Farm's Multiple Line Discount, see me, Trish Hauser.
Going to the dentist has never been on people's favorite things to do list. That's why Dr. Anthony Lupinetti goes out of his way to assure you and your family that we're a little different. Using the latest technology, Dr. Lupinetti is able to let you sit in luxury and comfort while he keeps your teeth and gums healthy. Welcome our new associate, Dr. Matt Green, a York Catholic grad. Open daily Monday through Friday. For an appointment, call 854-3310. For more info, visit SpringwoodDental.com. Dr. Anthony Lupinetti, 2084 Springwood Road, York.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York. First in sports.
Back at York Catholic, Ron Ruman and Gareth Hisong with you as the Irish get ready for Bermudian Springs in the high school football game of the week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Time now for our starting lineups courtesy of Trish Hauser, your local State Farm agent. You mentioned the Halloween-like sunset, Gareth. We've got all the guys with their Halloween masks on in the booth tonight. Pretty scary stuff, too, I'm telling you. 30 of us in here. It's built for six, but that's all right. So let's get our starting.
Still waiting for the Sanderson sisters to fly by on some brooms.
All right, let's get our lineup here before they throw us out. All right.
Starting at quarterback, the four-year starter, fantastic football player to watch, number 11, the senior, Daniel Kemick, 6'1". 180 pounds at fullback, number 40, Carter Sinclair at running back, Jakar Kennard, the main target on the perimeter at wide receiver, number 10, Brendan Kennedy, at wide receiver, Riley Brennan, tight end, Ryan Soule, at tackle, Liam Landis and Matt Knauer, your guards, Mike McKim, Adam Bittner, and at center, Harris Cole.
All right, and let's get the Bermudian Springs Eagles, also 6-1 and 4-0.
In the backfield, at quarterback, number 10, Chase Dahl. Fullback, Ashton West. Number 9, at running back, Devin Hogden. At Z out receiver, Ben Edgenrider. At wide receiver, Quentin Nace. Tight end, Trevor Grimm. Your offensive line goes Forsyth, Becker, Wheeler, Steele, and Epley.
All right, our starting lineups from Trish Hauser, your local State Farm agent. Bermudian Springs and York Catholic for first place in Division III tonight from the Irish football field. We're going to take a break back with our Apple Ford keys to the game after this in the high school football game of the week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on Sports Radio 1350 and GameTimePA.com.
Do you know why Apple Ford of Redline is York County's most loved Ford dealer?
I got $5,000 in bonus cash and dealer discounts off my new 2016 Ford Focus.
I got 0% financing, 72 months, and $500 military appreciation bonus cash.
Check out Apple Ford's hundreds of positive online reviews. Then visit York County's most loved Ford dealer at Apple Ford or GoAppFord.com. Offers with approved credit. Examples include all manufacturer offers and dealer discounts. See dealer for details. Offers are 103160.
Yorktown Roofing and Siding, locally owned and operated since 1992. The premier building materials distributor in central PA. Distributors of roofing and siding, windows and doors, decking and railing, seamless gutter and gutter guard, and cabinets and vanities. Both wholesale and retail. Located at 261 Northeast Street in York. Online at yorktownroofingandsiding.com or call 845-9447 or toll free at 1-800-457-3943.
So you're dialing an 800 number to see if you can save money on car insurance. That's fine, but try asking where you're calling.
So anyway, where am I calling?
San Antonio, Texas.
Bahaba.
Tuscaloosa, Alabama.
Why not call your local neighborhood Donegal agent instead? Donegal's auto insurance rates are routinely among the lowest in the state. And with Donegal, safe drivers save even more. Plus, by working with a local independent insurance agent, you get professional advice from someone you may already know. Save money on your auto insurance through your local Donegal agent. Donegal Mutual Insurance, there when it matters most. As an independent agent, Harry L. Bubb Associates is dedicated to helping you through every step of the insurance process. Bubb Insurance is conveniently located in Hanover, Shrewsbury, and Red Lion. Call or visit Harry L. Bubb Associates today.
Live, local, sports is on Sports Radio 1350, WOIK.
sports injury, walk into WellSpan Urgent Orthopedics for immediate care. No appointment is ever needed. Our orthopedic and sports medicine specialists are here to treat you. Visit WellSpan.org/urgent orthopedics today for hours at our York and Hanover locations.
Every day, Fast Signs helps businesses like yours with their visual communications. We ask the right questions, recommend smart solutions, and help you build your business. Our knowledgeable consultants uncover your communication challenges and provide visible solutions. At Fast Signs, we're innovators, planners, and designers. We're more than fast, more than signs, and we're more than ready to help. Contact Fast Signs today.
Visit our store next to Sam's Club in East York or visit us online at fastsigns.com.
To get ready for every Penn State football game, keep it on Sports Radio 1350. I'm Ron Ruman, and each week during the fall, I'll bring you the latest on this Saturday's game with comments from Coach James Franklin and the Lion players. Listen for reports throughout the day, Wednesdays through Fridays, brought to you by Penn State York, your neighborhood SureSave Markets, and financial advisor Dave Sprinkle. For your Penn State football fix, stay tuned to Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
There's only one place for local high school sports, Sports Radio 1350.
About ready to go with our Fast Signs opening kick. Vet's got our Appleford keys to the game first from Gareth Hissong. All right, Gareth, the Bermudian Springs Eagles come in here looking for a big win tonight. They beat the Irish by 3 points last year. What's the key for the Eagles this evening?
Offensively, get that prolific running attack going. They come out with the wing tee offense. They have to take care of the football tonight. Defensively, stop the big plays over the top from York Catholic passing attack.
And for the Fighting Irish tonight,
Bermudian Spring comes in here at -2 in the turnover margin. York Catholic has to take advantage of that, be ball hungry and aggressive, try to get some turnovers. Field is in good condition, but it's still a little slick because of the rain we got earlier tonight, make the ball a little slippy. They got to get some turnovers if they're going to come out with a win here at home against Bermudian Springs.
All right, those are our Apple Ford keys to the game for tonight as we await our Fast Signs opening kickoff and the Huntersville Ortho first quarter. Irish in their home uniforms, for those of you listening on radio, in green jerseys, the gold helmets, the gold pants, and the gold numbers, and Bermudian, the traveling uniforms, white shirts, red numbers, gray pants. Pants with the red stripe and the red helmet. Big game in the division. Gareth, in Division 3, really the winner tonight, especially if York Catholic wins. They've already beaten Littlestown. Bermudian has Littlestown next week. The Irish can win tonight. Two games remaining, Fairfield and York Tech. Now, those teams, you know, 5-6 years ago, you would have penciled them in as automatic wins. That's not the case anymore, but I think, truly, if the Irish win tonight, those are two games they should be able to win. So, a lot on the line for this evening.
Absolutely, and playing here in front of a home crowd. Very fortunate they get this matchup at home where they're more comfortable. We were talking up here in the booth about every time you play at Bermudian Springs, that grass is a little bit higher. Slows teams down. You know, I don't know if it's that much of an advantage, but it's great that York Catholic gets to play a tough Bermudian Springs team at home.
Yeah, indeed. It's always better to be at home. And the Irish won the toss and deferred, so they will kick it off to get us started. And that means Nick Basil will be booting it. And deep is Trevor Hogden for the Eagles. He's been doing a lot for them recently. And
Ron, I've been keeping a closer eye on things at Vegas and seeing how games shake out.
Uh-huh.
One thing I've heard a lot, be weary of the home dogs.
All right. Is that for me and with Penn State tomorrow?
Yeah. Well, they might cover the 20 points.
Yeah, they might. They might or might not. All right, we're ready to roll here with a fast science opening kick.
They put Julius Jones at linebacker. They'll be okay.
Absolutely. And the kick is a high end-over-end kick, and Hogdon settles under it at the 5. And Devin straight up the field, cuts to the left now, gets to the outside, and is met right about the 27 or 28-yard line. And Brendan Kennedy on the hit for the Irish there, and so Bermudian will have it first and 10. See where they mark this thing, somewhere around the 30.
Good tackle by
right at the 30.
Good tackle by Kennedy. Had plenty of open lanes. Kennedy had to make a play. A good sound tackle to stop a big return.
All right, Bermudian. First and 10 at the 30-yard line as the wind kicks up here. And Chase Dahl under center. And he will give it off to Ashton West off left tackle, and he's out to about the 33 or 34-yard line where the right side of the Irish line stops him there. And Riley Brennan on the stop. Gain of about 4 for Ashton West, and it'll be second down and 6.
See a lot of the downhill runs from this wing T offense of Bermudian. As usual with that wing T style, you only see a handful of plays they really run, and something's working, they'll stay with it.
Wide receiver up to the top of the formation and one to the near side here as well, and they hand it off to Hogdon looking for running room, gets off right tackle and gets out to about the 36 or 37 yard line. Ryan Sewell and Daniel Kemick on the stop, and Ryan Sewell is having a great year defensively. He's averaging 10 tackles a game and has 10 tackles for loss. It's a gain of 3 for Hogdon, and it'll be third down and about 3 for the Eagles.
And Sewell, senior, 6 foot, 175 pounds. Key for this defense and stopping this Eagles rushing attack. This is a crucial down, 3rd and 4. This is the down that York Catholic has to win and get the defense off the field.
Dahl under center, back split behind him. 3rd down and about 3. 4-man front for the Irish. Hand it off to West. Flag flies. West had it out to the 42-yard line, but there that was tossed. That's typically a hold. West used his blockers well. He hesitated till the hole opened, but the call is going to be a hold against Bermudian, and that's going to move him back. The flag is lying at the 38. That's a 10-yard spot foul. So that's going to make it 3rd down and about 12 for the Eagles. And what do we say about those penalties, Gareth?
Drive killers. A big break for this Irish defense. These 3rd downs are crucial to be successful in this game. Bermudian Springs has this kind of rushing attack where if they get a couple first downs, they hold onto the ball, win the possession battle. Makes it tough sledding for any opponent.
Coming into this game, Devin Hogdon with 567 yards on the ground, and Ashton West 613. West with 12 touchdowns, so they can move it on the ground, but now they're 3rd and 12. We'll see if they go to the air. The sophomore Chase Dahl, 28 out of 62, 542 yards, 4 touchdowns, has been intercepted 5 times. 3rd and 12, Dahl under center, puts a man in motion. It's Egan Ryder away from us, and they're going to hand it off to Hogdon. Hogdon up the middle, but big Liam Landis is there to ride him down at the 33. It's a 5-yard gain, but well short of the first down, and that's going to be a 4th down and a unique physique punt.
Big stop early for this Irish defense. This is that 3rd phase of the game. The special teams that always come in have a major impact. See if the Irish can get a big return here early in this ball game.
And Devin Hogdon is going to punt it. Good snap to him, and he gets it away. Good high kick, and Manuel Montez makes the fair catch at the 40 for the Irish. So the Irish defense gets a 3 and out, and the Irish will have pretty good field position at their own 40. 1st and 10 with 9:29 left here in the Hunters Hill Ortho first quarter. No score between the Irish and the Eagles.
Anxious to see Danny Okemic, the senior quarterback, and how he conducts this offense. He's a 4-year starter. We saw him as a freshman and sophomore a good bit. He played wide receiver, kind of a slot guy. Very talented athlete. See how he does at quarterback.
He'll work out of the shotgun. Yokemik, 46 of 83 on the year, takes the snap and gives it off to Jakar Kennard, who cuts to the near side now, looking for the corner, but can't get it. Good play by Trevor Grimm defensively. Kept Kennard from getting to the corner and drops him for a loss of three back at the 37. It'll be second down and 13.
More to the tune of Danny Yokemik. He does it all. Comes into this game, 547 yards rushing. As you mentioned, 846 passing yards, and there he does. Has a nice block on the edge.
Fakes it to Kennard, and Yokemik keeps it, dives out across the 40 to the 41. So he gets about four. As Aaron Becker on the stop that time for the Eagles. Actually, they'll mark it at the 40, so Yokemik gets the three back, and it's going to be third and 10 for the Irish at their own 40.
Third and 10.
Be nice for this Irish offense if they could get the running game going there. Facing a tough task. Defensive front for Bermudian goes 210, 273, 225, 225.
On third long, Yokemik drops to throw. Pressure comes. They set up a screen to the fullback, Carter Sinclair, and he slipped as he went to make his cut and goes down at the 39-yard line. Was pretty well defensed anyway. Ryan Forsyth was there. It's going to be a loss of one. That's going to be a fourth down. That'll bring up another unique physique punt as Jordan Williams will drop into punt formation.
Not long after we started our broadcast, the wind really started to pick up. York Catholic has to take advantage because right now they're punting with the wind. This is big for their field position.
Here's the snap. It's high, and Williams is going to run with it. And they're going to run a fake here, whether it was designed or not. He gets a block, and he should have the first down. Got just across midfield, and that's going to be a gain of about 11, and they needed 10. And a great block on the corner that time by Kyle Dormer, I think, is the guy that got him that extra yard. It's a 49 of Bermudian and a first down.
Not a design fake, that's just something they saw studying tape. Nice to have a punter with that kind of awareness. He's able to catch it, have the fortitude to look. Anytime you see some open green, take it. He had plenty.
So first and 10 for the Irish at the Eagles 49. Yokemik out of the gun, fakes it to Kennard and keeps it. Gets down to about the 47, gain of two. Pretty good defense that time by the Eagles as Epley is there. Noah Epley there to make the stop. Gain of two for Yokemik, and it'll be second down and eight.
Been a nice matchup early in this ball game. Adam Bittner, Noah Epley going at it.
Second and eight now, and they straight up the middle. They go with Kennard. Gets away from the first guy. Gets to the outside and puts the shoulder into Trevor Grimm. Gets it down to the 43. He'll pick up four. From there, it's going to be third and long three for the Irish.
Trevor Grimm,
not much room running against this defensive front again. Ryan Forsyth comes in. He's 6'1", 273-pound senior. Meets the running back in the hole. Remag able to scramble, make something out of nothing. The Irish are set up with a third and three.
Four wide receivers. Yokemik to throw. Stands in the pocket. Fires it, and just beyond his diving wide receiver at the 30-yard line was going for Brendan Kennedy, but just beyond him. So that's going to leave the Irish with a fourth down and about three, and they will drop into punt formation. So another unique physique punt is on the horizon.
Our Irish have in store.
And there you see Danny Yokemik. That's what happens when you have an athlete playing quarterback. Gets a little ball happy, not as settled. Makes an early throw.
Snap to Williams. He's going to punt this one. Nobody deep for Bermudian, and they didn't really believe it. Hits at the five, and they're going to be able to down it about the 2-yard line. Benefit of that kind of soft field with the rain, and hustling down there for the Irish was Antonio Staub. And so Bermudian with 6:11 left here in the first quarter. The Hunters Hill Ortho first quarter will start at their own about 2.5-yard line.
Ladies and gentlemen, on that touch as well.
It's a major opportunity for York Catholic to get a stop and force a punt on this defensive possession, continue to win the battle of field position and try to get on the board early against Bermudian. See if Bermudian can get a couple positive plays and get from the shadow of their own field goal post.
All right, Chase Dahl again under center now as a man in motion, and they give it straight ahead and they move it out to about the 5-yard line.
Ashton West gets the call.
West on the call. Adam Bittner on the stop. Gain of three out to the five. Be second down at about seven.
About 2 yards. Second down and eight.
You're limited with your play calling when you're lined up, backed up inside your own 10-yard line, but if you take the chance to go to the air, Devin Ogden, a great receiver out of the backfield.
I think Ogden just went to the sideline, though. So we will see what they do. They've got Wheeler and West in the backfield right now. Dahl under center on second down at about seven, and they're going to give it off to, I believe that's West. And West may have forged a yard or so, although it looks like they're going to mark him right about the line. Well defensed by the Irish as...
Chris Young gets the call up left to center. Brewer on the tackle, Matthew Brewer on the takedown.
Looks like they marked that right about the line of scrimmage, and it's going to be third down at about seven.
Still a long seven.
Another key third down for this Irish defense as they try to get their unit off the field.
So third down and about seven now. Man in motion in the backfield, and they give it off the right side, and twisting out to about the near the 10-yard line is West. And Ashton West got the 10, but he needed to get the 12. He's going to be a couple of yards short.
Takes a break off right side, goes to...
So a gain of
gain on the play. Going for fourth down.
Gain of five is going to be fourth down.
2 yards to go as
and two.
Up for a punt.
So we'll have a unique physique punting.
Back in the end zone.
The Eagles. Devin Hogan is the punter. Good snap. Gets it off. Good high kick. And Montez is going to field and falls down. Slipped a little bit on the field at about the 47-yard line of Bermudian. So a good punt of about 37 yards. No return, but the Irish will still be in good shape on the Eagles' side of the field at the 47.
Going to bring it up to about the 47.
Kudos to this Irish defense forcing two early three and outs. Setting up their offense. Great field position. York Catholic starting at the 47-yard line of Bermudian, moving from our right to left.
All right, 4:01 left in the first, still no score. Our first quarter brought to you by Hunter's Hill Ortho, and Daniel Kemick will go out of the gun. He's got two wide receivers, one to the top. That's Kennard, puts him in motion, fakes it to him. Kemick keeps it straight up the middle, and a big hole, and Dan is down near a first down. Looks like he's going to be about a yard shy as it's to the 38. And it's going to be a gain of nine for Yokemik, and it'll be second down and one.
Such an asset to have this kind of athlete at quarterback. When you're able to get him running the ball as much as he does, gives you an extra blocker at offensive unit.
Dan came in with 93 carries, 547 yards. Almost a 6-yard average and six touchdowns on the ground. Second and short, Yokemik takes the snap, gives it to Kennard, straight up the middle, he's got all, and runs over a man at the 26-yard line, and the pile pushes him forward down to near the 20-yard line. Great burst by Kennard and kept it going as Ben Egenrider made the stop. They'll mark it at the 23-yard line. That's a gain of 15 and a first down for the Irish, knocking on that door of that Weckers Carpet red zone.
Downhill run by Jakar Kennard. In the month of October, that's a monster mash kind of hit.
Kennard in motion away from us. Now high snap. Yokemik brings it down. Face to Kennard. Keeps it up the middle. Big hole again off the right side. Shedding tacklers inside the 15. And Dan Yokemik is down to the 10-yard line. That's a gain of 13. And another first down for the Irish. And I believe this is going to be a first and goal at the 10-yard line. Clock winds, 2:50 remaining here in the Hunter's Hill Ortho first quarter. No score, but the Irish in the Weckers Carpet red zone and threatening at the 10, first and goal. Yokemik hands it off to Kennard off the left side, dives forward to about the 5-yard line before he is hit by Darren Beal. Beal, the leading tackler for the Eagles, gain of four down to the 6. It'll be second and goal from there for the Irish.
Chris Young finds the takedown.
Inside the red zone, just keep it up the middle. Follow the guard, senior, 5'11", 240, Adam Bittner, and the center, Harris Cole, 5'10", 210 pounds, sophomore.
Yeah, Kemick gives it to Kennard, looking to get wide on the near side, gets a block from his wide receiver at the five, and he's pushed out, I believe, just shy. He is out just a yard or two shy. Brenton Krebs and Dorian Steele force him out there. He's going to be at the one-yard line. It's a gain of five by Jakar, and it's going to be third down and goal from the inside the one, Irish.
Special foam fingers supported by IGS Energy this evening.
Look for quarterback Danny Yokemik. On a quarterback sneak, see if he can get his seventh rushing touchdown.
He is under center, takes it. No, he's going to hand it to Kennard. Kennard, the middle line, and dives into the end zone. Jakar Kennard with a one-yard touchdown run. And with 2:04 left in the first quarter, the Irish take the 6-0 lead.
Such a dynamic duo in the backfield. Quarterback Danny Yokemik and running back Jakar Kennard. Kennard punches in his eighth rushing touchdown of the season.
All right, so the Irish with a drive that started in Eagle territory after the punt, but it was a good drive nonetheless, and Nick Basilon for the kick. Kyle Dormer will be the holder, and Matt Knauer is the long snapper.
We've got Kyle Dormer on the hold for Nicholas Basil for the point after.
Snap is there, the set is down, and the kick by Basil is up, and it is through. 2:04 left in the Huntersville Ortho first quarter. York Catholic 7, Bermudian Springs nothing. Take a break and come back for more of the high school football game of the week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on Sports Radio 1350 and GameTimePA.com.
Hunter's Hill Orthodontics is a longtime staple in the orthodontic care community. With offices in York and Dillsburg, our practice's top priority is to provide you with the highest quality orthodontic care in a friendly, comfortable environment. Call our York offices, 1910 Kenneth Road, at 767-6694 to make your appointment, or at 1399 South Queen Street, 885-5468. Or in Dillsburg, call 502-1186. We've got your smile at Hunter's Hill Orthodontics.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Join me weekday mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
And welcome back to York Catholic, the Fighting Irish. Getting the home crowd fired up as they take a 7-0 lead here with 2:04 left in the Hunter's Hill Ortho first quarter. And we'll have our Yorktown Roofing and Siding scoring recap here in just a moment. We're about to have a fast signs kick from Nick Basil.
Friends from Game Time PA
and see if
we're going live streaming.
Bermudian can get anything going on. Deborah Hogden is deep.
We welcome one and all.
And Basil approaches it and hits it. And it's taken by one of the upmen. That's Brenton Krebs at about the 11-yard line. Krebs up the left side and is out to about the 30 or 31-yard line.
Nicholas Basil. Find some running room.
And the tackle for the Irish on the special teams play is there by Jordan Williams. Let's get our Yorktown Roofing and Scoring Siding scoring recap.
Well, defense forces two three and outs for York Catholic. And on their second offensive possession, a heavy dose of Kennard and Yokemik. Kennard finishes a 47-yard drive after five plays with a one-yard touchdown run for his eighth rushing touchdown of the season. York Catholic is up 7-0.
And Dahl going to throw. Flake rolls right, has some time, flips it out to Hogden in the flat. Hogden sheds one guy and gets out to about the 35-yard line before Adam Bittner knocks him out of bounds. And it's going to be a gain of about four. It'll be second and six for the Irish.
Following a gain on a play of about
not surprised to see the Eagles go to the air, try to mix things up on offense as they've had zero success on their first two possessions, namely due to this stout defense for the Irish. They go to the air, try to mix it up and put this defense on their heels a little bit.
Yeah, try and open up that D a little bit. Center Russell Wheeler out over the football on a second down and six from the Eagle 35. 1:49 left in the first. Dahl hands it off to Hogden, who's hit in the backfield by Ryan Sewell, who gets his 11th tackle for loss of the season as he came blowing through there and drops Hogden at the 33. It's a loss of two, and it's going to be third down and nine for the Eagles.
We've already mentioned his name a couple times tonight. He's a senior. Clocks in at 6 foot, a 1.75, cleaning things up for the defense.
All right, so Hogden and the rest of the Eagle runners and Webb. West have had trouble getting the going tonight. And it's third down and nine now at the Eagle 33. See if they go to the air. As Ashton West and Devin Hogden are the backs behind Chase Dahl, who's under center. Takes the snap, and he's going to throw. Play fake, has some time. Goes deep down the middle, and he has a man. It is Chase David, and it's broken up at the last minute as hustling back there was Brendan Kennedy, and it actually hit Kennedy on the helmet as there was a hair underthrown because David was open and behind the defense, but good hustle by Kennedy. Get back and break that one up, and that'll leave it with a fourth down and a unique physique punt.
And Sinclair really just put his head down. He knew he was beat and just chugged it downfield. Kennedy using his head to break up the pass.
Yeah, really. Well, he did. Got it done. 59 seconds left in the quarter, and there's the punt by Hogden. It's high, fairly short. Montez makes the fair catch at the Irish 41-yard line. So with 54 seconds left here in the first quarter, York Catholic has it again in good field position at their own 41, leading it 7-0.
And again, a strong wind the Eagles had to kick into. York Catholic needs to capitalize on this possession before they're facing that wind.
Now the flag in the end zone to our left is blowing pretty good right now. They said it was going to be windy this evening, but so far the rain has held off. First and 10 to the Irish, and Yochemic in the gun as a wide receiver. Riley to the near side now, and he hands it to Kennard off the right side, following his blockers, has a hole, and is out to about the 47-yard line. It's going to be a gain of about six.
Ashton West on the takedown for the Eagles. A large gain.
Ashton West on the stop and gain out to the 48. It's a gain of almost seven for Jacquard. It'll be second down at about three and a half for the Irish. And Yochemic turns, hands it to Kennard again. He blasts off the left side, big hole, and almost ran over the man, Brenton Krebs. He and Darren Beal bring the stop, but down to the 41-yard line of Bermudian. That is a gain of 11 and a first down for the Irish.
And it's been just about all Kennard and Yochemic toting the rock so far tonight. What do we got for numbers?
All right, Kennard has 8 carries already. 19, 22, 27, 28, 35, 43 yards for Kennard. And Yochemic, 4 carries and 27 yards. Jordan Williams, 11 on the fake punt. So that's going to be the end of the first quarter. We've played one. The Irish 7, the Eagles nothing. The Broadway transmission, second quarter, comes your way next on the High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on Sports Radio 1350 and Game Time.
Crown's Orchards and Farm Market in Loganville was built on teamwork, commitment, and passion. For over 65 years, Brown's has been a delicious destination for hand-picked fruit and award-winning bakery treats. As we celebrate football season, make Brown's Catering your tailgating headquarters for barbecue, party trays, wings, steamed shrimp, giant 2-foot subs, and more. Brown's applauds every football player, coach, cheerleader, band member, and parent for your teamwork, commitment, and passion for the game. Come to Brown's in Loganville to celebrate the big win. Brownsorchards.com.
The home for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Serving York for over 50 years, Vito's Pizza. Check out their daily lunch specials Monday through Friday, 11 till 2. Two slices of pizza and a small soda, only $3.99, or a small sub for only $4.25. Monday night, two large cheese pizzas for only $15.99. Tuesday, a large stromboli and large pitcher of soda, just $11.99. Wednesday, a large cheese pizza and large pitcher of soda, just $11.49. Vito's open till midnight, Monday through Thursday, till 1 a.m., Fridays and Saturdays. Dine in at 1734 South Queen Street, York, or get carryout. Call 843-1143.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports.
And we switch sides. The Irish moving left to right now as we start the second quarter. Montez in motion. Yochemic fakes it, keeps it off the right side, and he is hit by Aaron Becker. And that's a gain down to the 38-yard line. It's a gain of 3, actually about 4 from the 42 to the 38. And it'll be skin down and 6 from there.
Peel on the takedown.
York Catholic continues to fake.
Tackle for the
jet sweep.
Second down.
Keep the Eagles defense honest.
Yochemic Gives it to Kennard off the left side. Jakar looking for the corner, and Trevor Grimm strung it out pretty well. And he is hit over there by Grimm and Addison Wheeler. And got down to about the 35-yard line, so gain of three, and for the Irish, it's going to leave them with a third down and about four.
See if this Eagles defense can bow up and get a stop and get off the field. So momentum has been all with the Irish tonight.
Third down, a long three, the Irish, the Eagle 35-yard line. Yokemik rolling right, looking to throw. Fires it out, and Brendan Kennedy makes a diving catch at the 30-yard line, and that's going to be enough for a first down. He laid out to get that one. It'll be a gain of five, and that'll move the sticks for the Irish.
Finally get to see Brendan Kennedy on the perimeter, showcasing his athletic ability. Last week, hauled in 206 receiving yards.
Man, that is a lot, especially in a high school game. And Kennard following the fullback into the hole, spins. It's down to about the 28-yard line. Pretty well defense. Noah Epley in there on the stop for Bermudian, along with Ryan Forsyth. The ball's at the 28. And it's a gain of two for Kennard, and it'll be second down and eight for the Irish at the Eagle 28 line.
Been a smooth, clean game so far. Not many penalties, only one holding penalty against Bermudian so far as we approach 10 minutes left in the second quarter.
Yeah, Kemikai snap, keeps it after the play fake to his left, but not much there. Trevor Grimm again on the play there with Dorian Steele, and a gain of about a yard or so. And it's going to be third down and about seven for the Irish. Trevor Grimm playing a good game on the edge so far tonight for the Eagles.
Trevor Grimm's the leader of this defense. He calls the plays, gets guys organized and lined up, does a great job. Doing his job, as you saw in that last play, setting the edge of the defense, forcing the ball carriers back inside.
Yeah, Kemik to throw on third down. A lot of time now rolling to his right. He's going to tuck it and run. He's at the 25 and upended at around the 23-yard line. Darren Beal on the stop. And he's going to be stopped at the 22-yard line, about 2 yards short of the first down. So it's going to be fourth and two for the Irish from there.
One thing I've been impressed with this entire season, Ron, saw it last week with Spring Grove and Central, some physical football players, some physical football games, and we've seen pads getting cracked here tonight.
Fourth and two now, Yokemik keeps it straight ahead. He goes big hole up the middle, and Yokemik is finally dragged down by Tim Krebs, but not before he gets to the 11-yard line. It's a gain of 11. We're in the Weckers Carpet Red Zone, and the Irish with a first down, 8:43 left in the Broadway Trans second quarter.
Got to be disheartening for this Eagles defense as Yokemik and Kennard continue to run right up the heart of the defense.
And they give it to Kennard off the left side. Big hole. Jakar dances inside the five. And he got down to about the 2-yard line. And the Eagles are saying they have the football. Haven't seen anybody with a striped shirt say it yet. One of the Eagles came out of there with it. But the Eagles, I think, are saying he was down. And the officials are saying he was down. So it's a gain down to about the 3. Gain of almost 8 for Jakar Kennard. And it'll be second down and about 2 or 3 from there for the Irish.
The Eagles coming into this ball game minus 2 in a turnover margin. They use a turnover right now.
Oh, and the snap is fumbled. And I think Yokemik was able to dive on it. And I think the Irish did get it back. So they're going to mark this at the right about the same line of scrimmage. So looks like little or no loss on the play, but most importantly, the Irish kept the ball. So it's third down and about 2.5 for the Irish. The ball is just inside the 4. Full house backfield now with Yokemik and Sinclair in front of Kennard. Kennard gets it, trying to get to the outside, and is not going to do it, as blowing through there for the Bermudian Springs Eagles was Addison Wheeler from a linebacker spot to hit Kennard in the backfield, dropped him at about The five, loss of about a yard or two, and it's going to be fourth down for the Irish, and we'll see what they decide to do here. Looks like they're going to, go. And now the Irish are going to, well, Bermudian's going to take a timeout. 6:50 left in the first half. York Catholic 7. Nothing. We'll be back after this timeout on Sports Radio 1350 and Game Time PA, a high school football game of the week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine.
Coachman and Conkle Insurance Group, part of the Keystone Insurers Group, can save you 15 to 50% for just 15 minutes of your time. We customize plans for your needs and find you the best rate and protection. Discounts for good driver, good student, homeowners, renters, and multiple policies. Plus health, life, and all types of business insurance. Locally owned by Rudy and Pam Coachman, 3217 East Market Street, York. Call 854-0300 or online at kigyork.com. Coachman and Conkle Insurance Group, a proud supporter of local high school sports.
Morning at 9, Dan Patrick on Sports Radio 1350, WOIK.
All right, out of the timeout, the Irish fourth and goal from about the, or fourth and actually not goal, fourth and a long three from about the five. They can get a first down here. You know, Kemp in the gun, takes the snap, stands in the pocket, fires for the end zone, and out of the end zone, he's going for Kennedy in the back of the end zone, but good defense, so it is incomplete, and on downs, the Irish will turn it over to Bermudian, and will take over first and 10 at their own 5-yard line. The Eagles trailing at 7-0 with 6:46 left here in the Broadway transmission second quarter.
Thank you for being here tonight.
Thank you. Appreciate being noted to the crowd here for 1350 in game time. It's the battle for first place here in Division 3. Both teams at 4-0 in the division and 6-1 overall. So Chase Dahl under center now.
First and 10 for the Eagles.
Man in motion. Dahl takes the snap and gives it off to Hogden. And Devin Hogden gets to the corner, gets out to about the 10-yard line. Like going to gain about five on the stop for the Irish. Maybe second down about five for there.
Second down and six.
It's the second possession out of four that Bermudian has been starting.
Second down.
At or inside their own 10-yard line. It's been tough sledding for this offense. Crucial to get momentum on this drive.
Dahl under center, wide receiver to the near side. Takes the snap, and they hand it straight ahead. Not much there. In fact, little or no gain. I believe that was Ashton West, and he really got nothing. It's going to be third down and about six, and AKA tough sledding William against the big guys. Landis at 6'5", 330, Knauer 6'4", 275 in the middle of that defensive line for the Irish. A lot of beef there. Third down at about six, Bermudian in its own 9-yard line, and Dahl under center, he's going to throw. Drops straight back, fires it deep down the near side for David, and David unable to run under it, running stride for stride with Matt Brewer, and unable to haul it in at the 45-yard line. So that's going to be incomplete, fourth down, and Bermudian's going to have to punt it. A unique physique punt, and Kevin Hogden will hit this one right around his own goal line there, Kara.
And unfortunately, the Eagles now have the wind to their backs. Will help them out a little bit with the punt. And keep an eye on those shots downfield. Bermudian's taken two deep shots, and they've had a chance on both of them.
And Hogden has to tie his shoe before he can kick this one. And now takes the snap in the end zone, gets it away. Angles for the sideline here. Montez lets it hit, and it's going to go out of bounds at the 49-yard line of York Catholic. So the Irish again will have good field position. They're actually going to mark it right about midfield. So the Irish will have it first and 10 right around midfield. And it's, Gareth, a game of field position. The Irish have started a drive in Bermudian Springs territory, started one at their own 41. This one they start right at midfield. And Bermudian, conversely, has been backed up.
Yeah, you said that their first possession, they start toward a yard line, seven plays. didn't get a score on that first possession. Their second possession at the 47-yard line of Bermudian. Score a touchdown on that possession. Their last possession started on the 41, and here they are at the 49-yard line.
You have Kemick in the gun, wide receiver each way, gives it to Kennard straight ahead, hops to the left around a guy. Ashton West grabs him along with Trevor Grimm and Darren Beal. And a flag flies late. It was a gain of about six to the 44 Bermudian, and then some stuff at the end there, and we'll see what the call is here. Personal foul against Bermudian. So that's going to tack on 15 to the six-yard gain by Kennard. And that'll move it down to the 29-yard line. A first down with 5:04 left. And Bermudian is trying, as you say, bow it up on defense. It's a one score game right now, but of the Irish. Now at the 29 of Bermudian with a first down.
Thought there was a little extracurricular activity on that last play. It's too early in this ball game for the Eagles to hurt themselves with frustration penalties.
You know, Kemick again from the gun. Sinclair to his left. Jakar Kennard, the deep back. And Kennard off the right side breaks a tackle at the line, breaks another tackle, still going, breaks a tackle at the 20, inside the 10 at the 5, and is forced out of bounds at around the 2-yard line. But Jakar Kennard with a big 27-yard run broke three tackles on the way. And it's going to be a first and goal for the Irish. Actually, they marked that at the 1. So it's a gain of 28 for Kennard, and first and goal for the Irish.
The Fighting Irish, stable of studs in the backfield for this offense. And the bell cow, Jakar Kennard, gets it down to first and goal.
Kennard, Yochemic under center, gives it to Kennard, dives into the end zone, leaped over the pile, and he is in pay dirt for the second time tonight. Couple of 1-yard touchdown runs for Jakar Kennard with 4:46 left here in the Broadway Trans second quarter. The Irish go up 13-0.
Kennard's been running hard all night. Able to use his leverage many times, lower his shoulder, run guys over. And there you see him with the ability to go over top as well. It's his second touchdown of night, ninth of the season.
All right, Nick Basil on for the PAT. Kyle Dormer will hold and Matt Knauer will snap it. A little bit of a high snap, but Dormer gets it down and it's blocked. The PAT is blocked, so it is no good. 4:46 left in the Broadway Trans second quarter. York Catholic 13, Bermuda brings nothing. Take a break, you're listening to the York Adams League High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on Sports Radio 1350 and Game Time PA.com.
When you need a haircut, where do you go? If you need a hair replacement, who's the expert? When barbers need a haircut, where do they go? The answer is Iaconos, of course, the most interesting barbers in York. Don't normally get a shave? Go to Iaconos, they'll take care of you. Need a facial? That's right, Iaconos is the place to get done. Iaconos, the most interesting barbers in York. They do it all. For an appointment, call 854-8258. That's 854-8258.
The home for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
And welcome back to York Catholic as the Fighting Irish have taken the 13-0 lead over Bermudian. 4:46 left before half. And we're going to have a Fast Signs kick and then our Yorktown Roofing and Siding scoring recap. And think key, Gareth, for the Eagles to get something going on offense here as they've really struggled. And the Irish are still within touch, but if the Eagles don't get something going offensively, it's going to be a long night.
Need to get some points on the board before halftime, so they have some momentum and something to talk about, some hope. It's getting chilly here. They need something to cheer them up.
And Nick Basil to hit for the Fast Signs kick. The ball bows off the tee, and Jake Hamilton will hold it now for Basil. Ogden is deep, standing around the 15-yard line. And here's the kick. A low bouncer picked up by one of the upmen at about the 37-yard line. And that's Wheeler. Wheeler to the outside at midfield. Wheeler down the far sideline inside the 40 and all the way down to about the 32-yard line. So
finds a lot of running.
Addison Wheeler, the running back, took that short kick and returns it to the Irish 32. So for the first time tonight, the Eagles have it in good field position to start a drive, and that is what the Eagles needed right then.
Exactly what these Eagles needed. They needed a turnover or a big play on special teams, and they got it. They need to use this momentum and capitalize on this offensive possession.
Nine carries tonight for Bermudian, but only 22 yards on the ground and 4 yards passing, so just 26 yards of total offense so far for Bermudian. Just 4:36 left in the second quarter. Dull under center. Takes the snap, drops to throw. Has time. Fires it deep. Going for Hogdon. Way overshoots him, though. He was double covered and bracketed that time by Riley Brennan and Daniel Kennick. So Dahl way overshot his intended receiver, Devin Hogdon, that time. He's the leading receiver. 11 catches and 244 yards coming in. But it's going to be second down and 10 from the 32.
This can be the issue when you run this wing T offense. If you can't get things going in a running game, you don't have a wide open playbook. You don't have a lot of options if things aren't working for you on your bread and butter plays.
So second and 10 at the 32. Dahl under center in motion away from us. Goes Hogdon to give it to the fullback straight ahead, and that is West. West broke one tackle, got to the 29 before Yokemik and some friends, including Carter Sinclair, grab him and toss backwards. So it's a gain of three. It's going to be third and 7 from the Irish 29.
You mentioned it on the last defensive possession, York Catholic at nose tackle. Number 77, the junior, Liam Landis, 6'5", 330 pounds. And they try to double-team him. And with this wing T offensive scheme, the blocking schemes, you're trying to get angles on guys. You don't want to just one-on-one, straight-up block. But they're putting guys on him, and that allows these linebackers to come in. Sinclair, Hamilton, Brennan, Kennedy to clean things up.
Third and 7 now for the Eagles of the Irish 29. Dahl under center takes the snap. He's going to throw. He's under pressure. They're setting up a screen. They get it back to West. He's got some blockers. He's at the 30, the 25, and the 20-yard line down to about the 18 before Ryan Sewell and Matt Brewer are able to bring him down. That was a well-set-up and well-executed screen by the Eagles.
Well-executed and well-timed. This defense having all kinds of success, expecting the pass, so they come upfield with a lot of pressure trying to get after the quarterback.
Ashton West gets the call.
The Eagles take advantage of that aggressiveness. Great time to call a screen and to keep this drive alive with a fresh set of downs at the 18-yard line of the Irish.
And so the Eagles inside the Weckers Carpet Red Zone for the first time tonight. Dahl under center, puts Hogdon in motion away from us, give it straight ahead to the fullback. That is Brenton Krebs, and he gets to the 15. It's a gain of 3, and it'll be second and 7 for the Eagles from there. 3 minutes left here in the Broadway Trans second quarter, and the big Liam Landis on the stop for the Irish.
Second down and long six.
Again, you see not much success keeping it between the tackles with their bread and butter plays. See if they try to mix it up and try to get on the perimeter.
Dahl under center, and oh, a lot of movement there. As a looked like most of the offense was going on one, and the center was going on two. And that's going to be illegal procedure on 6 or 7 of the Eagles, and that's going to move it back from the 15 to the 20. And there will be second down and 12 for the Eagles. So an unfortunate penalty for Bermudian.
Well, how would you feel if you're Russell Wheeler, the center, staring down the bow at Liam Landis? Like we said, he comes in here two T-bones deep at 330 pounds.
Second and 12. Wheeler's no small guy. He's at 252, but yeah, that's tough. And they get off to Wheeler trying to get outside. Now cuts it back, and Addison Wheeler gets back down to about the 16-yard line. Accidental mark at around the 17, so he got three. It's going to be third down about 11 for the Eagles.
Ron, we talk about it time and time again. Penalties, shooting yourself in the foot, those mistakes can drive killers. Bermudian not having much success on offense tonight. Hurt their momentum with the offside ball. It's 3rd and 9. This is 2-down territory. They're at the 19-yard line. See if they can overcome. overcome this adversity.
Dahl under center. He's going to throw straight back. Blitz comes. He gets it away and overshot his man. He's going for Ben Egenrider in the flat that time. Kemick in the coverage. So the incomplete will make it 4th and 9 at the 17. You know the Eagles got to go for it here because only a minute 44 left in the half. It's their first trip into the red zone tonight, and Hogdon trots back onto the field. He's their go-to guy.
We're coming into tonight. Chase Dahl. 62 attempts, 542 yards through the air. And tonight, two completions and six incompletions. Not in a good rhythm.
Yep, 15 yards passing tonight. Dahl 2 of 6. Timeout taken now. Is that your Catholic take the timeout? Bermudian. Bermudian took the timeout. So the second timeout by the Eagles. Thanks to Jeff Antoli, spotter extraordinaire, for that. So, buck 44 left. What do you call here, Gareth? It's 3rd and 9, then having success throwing, and it's tough to run for 9 yards against this Irish defense. They ran the screen successfully, but I'm not sure they'll catch the Irish on that one a second time.
I agree, but that execution was superb. With the wing tee offense, not a whole lot of options. Try to go with a waggle pass and just flood the open side of the field, which would mean Chase Dahl rolling out to his left.
Dahl under center now on 3rd and 9 from the Irish 17. And he is going to throw. He's rolling to his left. A lot of time now. Fires it back to Hogdon. Hogdon at the 23, at the 20, the 15, inside the 10. Still on his feet. He's into the end zone. You called it, my friend. A throw back and a good run with some nice downfield blocks. And Devin Hogdon is into the end zone. 17-yard touchdown pass from Chase Dahl, and with a buck 32 left in the half, we have a game. Irish 13, Eagles 6.
It's October, and the Bermudian Springs go with a little hocus pocus to strike on the board for their first time tonight and get back in this ball game. And after this point after, they'll be down.
Noah Epley on to attempt the PAT. Ben Egenrider is the holder.
Noah Epley back.
And Tyler Reinert is the snapper, and the kick is up and through. So with 92 seconds left in the half, the Eagles have taken advantage of the good position to start their drive, and they've tightened this thing up. It's Irish 13 and Eagles 7. They get the Yorktown Roofing and Siding scoring recap here for you in just a moment. As we approach the Vito's Pizza halftime show and the battle for first place in Division 3 tonight.
He's out of town and unable to be here tonight. Check us out on Game Time PA. Streaming live this evening, ladies and gentlemen.
And the Irish lead cut now to 13-7.
1350 WOYK.
With 1:32 left in the second quarter.
Stay tuned once again for
Bermudian able to capitalize on the great field position. After a nice kickoff return started at the 32-yard line of York Catholic, goes 7 plays, shoot themselves in the foot with a penalty, able to overcome that adversity with a nice throwback pass. Chase Dahl throws it to Devin Hogdon, his main target out of the backfield, and he runs it in for a 17-yard touchdown reception with a minute 32 before halftime. Bermudian is down 7-6.
Our fast signs kick. They bounce it along the ground. Finally picked up by, I believe it's Matt Brewer back there, and he's out across the 25 to about the 27-yard line. The Irish will start there. 1:25 left. The Irish have all their timeouts. So we'll see what they do. Kemick through the night, just 2 of 4 for 4 yards. They've been doing mostly on the ground. We'll see if Kemick goes through the air. He certainly can do that.
21-43.
And this is a battle for first place in Division 3. Both teams 4-0 and 6-1 overall. The Irish currently the top seed in District 3 AA, Bermuda and the 2 seed in AAA. So it's important for those district standings as well. Yokemik in the gun. Big snap, hands it off to Jakar Kennard. Straight ahead, now bounces it to the outside, uses the stiff arm, but it's not going to help him. He is hit and driven backward, and good defense by a lot of the Eagles that time. It was Epley that finally hit him, but I think it was Wheeler that strung that one out, and it's a loss of 4 back to the 23. It'll be second down and 14.
Second down and 14.
I spoke a minute ago. I said that Bermudian is down 7-6. I was thinking about the missed point after that York Catholic had. Mm-hmm. Bermudian's down 13-7 with 40 seconds left in the first half.
Yokemi fake the throw, gives it on a delayed handoff to Kennard. Big run up the middle. He's brought down by Trevor Grimm out at the 37-yard line. And it's a gain of about 12, and it's going to be third and one for the Irish.
It's been such a heavy dose of Kennard and Yokemi tonight. Kennard, you see him again right there. He's been running hard with a full head of steam. Uses leverage. He lowers his pads and lowers the boom on defenders.
Now that's going to be third down. They have second down on the marker. It's got to be third, right?
We are at York Catholic.
So they're measure.
So we have the home crowd working the yard marker over there, trying to keep it second down.
Yeah, right. They'll stretch it out from these balls at the 37. And he is short by about 4 inches. So it's going to be third down and inches for the Irish at their own 37. 26 seconds left. Now, York Catholic has all of its timeouts.
If he doesn't change that yard marker to third down, I better him a confession this weekend.
Oh, there you go. And he does. He heard you. He was worried about that. So they're going to run the clock when they put this in play. So the Irish have taken a timeout. No, nope, they wind the clock. And Yokemi in no hurry, so the Irish may be content to take this one to the locker room with the 6-point lead here. Or maybe trying to catch them sleeping and fire a deep pass. And Bermudian putting their safety back deep. 10 seconds left in the half. Yokemi looking at the clock, looking at the back judge. 5 seconds to get it off. Now takes the snap, gives it to Kennard. Kennard dancing to the outside and still running at midfield. Jakar at the 45 down to the 43-yard line, but that's the end of the half. So a nice 20-yard run by Jakar Kennard, but did not catch the Eagles sleeping there. And so we have reached the Vito's Pizza halftime show, and our score, York Catholic 13 and Bermudian 7. And thought this would be a good one for first place in Division 3. And it is 13-7, Irish leading the Eagles. Reached the halftime of the game. Vito's Pizza halftime show on the High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine, here on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK and GameTimePA.com.
Serving York for over 50 years, Vito's Pizza. Check out their daily lunch special. Monday through Friday, 11 till 2. Two slices of pizza and a small soda on $3.99 or a small sub for only $4.25. Monday night, two large cheese pizzas for only $15.99. Tuesday, a large stromboli and large pitcher of soda, just $11.99. Wednesday, a large cheese pizza and large pitcher of soda, just $11.49. Vito's open till midnight, Monday through Thursday till 1 a.m. Fridays and Saturdays. Dine in 1734 South Queen Street, York, or get carryout. Call 843-1143.
When she looks up and says, "Dad, I'm playing field hockey," try not to show fear. She's quite capable of joining that fury of females turning downfield, sticks in hand, ready to conquer and crush the opposition. In fact, in her mind, she's been ready to play. But you won't be ready until you take her to Flying Feet Sports Shoes.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet is the one place that makes sense of all the sports kids are into, especially field hockey footwear. No, it's not just sneakers, Dad. She'll need shin guards and socks, and don't forget hockey balls, stick bags, tape protective eyewear, and hockey sticks. Flying Feet covers every player, every size, every ability, even goalie sticks. Dad, you're about to get an education on the art of fierce female competitive instinct. But Flying Feet can help you navigate that treacherous turf. They've been outfitting field hockey players and entire teams since your wife played back in 83.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet Sports Shoes, 1511 Mount Rose Avenue, York, just off exit 11 by 83.
Beer and Soda Mart is your home for a wide variety of soda and snack. Now under new ownership, Beer and Soda Mart is owned and operated by Daniel and Lori and has a friendly and knowledgeable staff there to assist you. Also your one-stop shop for lottery tickets and gift cards. Be sure to like us on Facebook for specials and monthly giveaways. Stop by Beer and Soda Mart or call us at 246-2944. Beer and Soda Mart, just off Route 74 in the Dairyland Square Shopping Center in Redline.
Your teams all the time.
York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio
1350 WOYK. Welcome back to York Catholic High School. Ron Ruman and Gareth Hissong with you on the Vito's Pizza Halftime Show. And the Irish leading the Eagles 13-7 in the battle for first place in Division 3. Both these squads 4-0 in the league and 6-1 overall. And the Eagle band take the field to perform for the fans at halftime. They still haven't started the clock here. I guess the teams have not made it to the locker room. The official has not given the signal to wind the halftime clock here. And now they do so. We're going to get our Yorktown roofing and siding scoring recap from Gareth Hissong.
It's been mostly York Catholic dominating the line of scrimmage thus far in this ball game. Winning the ball possession. Two of their five possessions, they've had scoring drives. They have 28 plays so far. Bermudian Springs, four out of their five possessions were three and outs. Only 19 plays for them in the game so far in the first half. On the second possession, York Catholic went 47 yards in a minute 57 seconds. Five plays, finished with a one-yard touchdown run, Jakar Kennard. And with 2 minutes, 4 seconds left in the first quarter, York Catholic took the lead 7-0. Two possessions later, York Catholic, with great field position, goes 51 yards in only three plays. There's also a personal foul penalty for Bermudian on that drive. And that drive also capped off with a one-yard touchdown run from Jakar Kennard. Got his ninth rushing touchdown of the season with 4 minutes, 46 seconds left in the first half. York Catholic, after a missed point after attempt, took the lead 13, Bermudian 0. See if that missed extra point comes back to haunt the Irish. And Bermudian, on their last possession of the first half, after a great kickoff return, set up the 32-yard line of York Catholic, went 32 yards, seven plays. And on a throwback pass, Chase Dahl, quarterback, connects with Devin Hogden, his main target out of the backfield, and Hogden takes it 17 yards for a touchdown with a minute 32 seconds left in the first half. Gives us our halftime score, York Catholic 13, Bermudian Springs 7.
All right, our scoring recap brought to you by Yorktown Roofing and Siding as the Bermudian Springs Eagle Band performing for the fans here at halftime. A breezy, cool night, but no rain since about 5 o'clock this afternoon, so that's the good news. And, interesting, Gareth, the Eagles don't throw up much, but they threw two well-executed passes, that stretch, that screen, and then that throwback pass for the touchdown. Maybe caught the Irish a little bit off guard with that.
Right, they didn't throw much, so it means the passes that they do throw are usually well-executed. They practice those a lot. It was one of those things where you're not mediocre or good at a bunch of things. You're really good at a few things. But we also saw them take a couple shots downfield and had an opportunity with both of those shots as well. So I mentioned earlier, they had a tough time getting anything going with the ground game. See if they go to the air more in the second half and take some shots downfield.
13-7, York Catholic leading Bermudian on the Vito's Pizza Halftime Show. Take a break. Come back with the Cookman Kunkel Halftime Stats on the High School Football Game of the Week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine here on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK and GameTimePA.com.
Cokeman and Conkle Insurance Group, part of the Keystone Insurers Group, can save you 15 to 50% for just 15 minutes of your time. We customize plans for your needs and for the best rate and protection. Discounts for good drivers, good student, homeowners, renters, and multiple policies, plus health, life, and all types of business insurance. Locally owned by Rudy and Pam Cokeman, 3217 East Market Street, York. Call 854-0300 or online at KIGYork.com. Cokeman & Conkle Insurance Group, a proud supporter of local high school sports.
Hunters Hill Orthodontics is a longtime staple in the orthodontic care community. With offices in York and Dillsburg, our practice's top priority is to provide you with the highest quality orthodontic care in a friendly, comfortable environment. Call our York offices, 1910 Kenneth Road, at 767-6694 to make your appointment, or at 1399 South Queen Street, 885-5468. Or in Dillsburg, call 502-1186. We've got your smile at Hunters Hill Orthodontics.
Sports injury? Walk into Wellspan Urgent Orthopedics for immediate care. No appointment is ever needed. Our orthopedic and sports medicine specialists are here to treat you. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today for hours at our York and Hanover. Cobra locations.
Broadway transition? I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they do it.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our ATRA certified technicians. Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they help with financing. Still with my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA car save some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
First in York, first in sports. Sports Radio 1350, WOIK.
And welcome back to York Catholic. Ron Room and Gareth Hissong with you. The Vito's Pizza halftime now. York Catholic leading Bermudian Springs 13-7 in a good one. Battle for first place in Division 3 as the Eagle Band begins to wrap up their halftime show tonight. Let's get our halftime stats from Kochman Kunkel Insurance. For Bermudian, it's been tough sledding offensively tonight. Devin Hogden, who came into tonight's contest with an impressive total of 567 yards and a 9.9 yard per carry average. Four carries, just 10 yards tonight for Devin. Ashton West, six carries, 15 yards. Brenton Krebs, one for three. And Addison Wheeler, one for three. So the Eagles ground game, which came into tonight averaging 262 yards a game on the ground. 12 carries, 31 yards in the first half against the Irish defense. Sophomore quarterback Chase Dahl through the air, 3 of 7 for 32 yards. Does have one touchdown passing, though. And that caught by Devin Hogden, a throwback, 17-yard touchdown reception. Hogden with two catches for 21 yards. He's also their leading receiver, came in with 11 catches for 244 yards and two touchdowns. And Ashton West had one catch for 11 yards, so just 63 yards of total offense tonight for the Bermudian Springs Eagles in the first half. Now for the York Catholic Fighting Irish, they've had some impressive offense stats, but they are only up by 6 points here, and the Irish will get the second half kickoff. On the ground, Jakar Kennard, big first half, 17 carries, 121 yards, and 2 one-yard down runs. Kennard came into the night with 947 yards, so he has cracked 1,000-yard mark for the season as 9 rushing touchdowns now. Daniel Kemick, the quarterback, 9 carries, 46 yards. Jordan Williams had a fake punt scramble for 11 yards. The Irish, 26 carries, 178 yards on the ground in the first half. You know, Kemick through the air, not 2-4 for just 4 yards. Brendan Kennedy, 1 catch for 5, and Carter Sinclair, the fullback, 1 catch for minus 1 yard. So the Irish with 182 yards of total offense here in the first half, and they lead it 13-7. That's your Kochman Kunkel halftime stats here on the Vito's Pizza halftime show. For Catholic leading Bermudian 13-7 on the high school football game of the week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Take a break and back with our York Traditions Bank halftime scoreboard show after this on Sports Radio 1350 and GameTimePA.com.
You know why Apple Ford of Redline is York County's most loved Ford dealer?
I got $5,000 in bonus cash and dealer discounts off my new 2016 Focus.
I got 0% financing for 72 months and $500 military appreciation bonus cash.
Check out Apple Ford's hundreds of positive online reviews. Then visit York County's most loved Ford dealer and Apple Ford or GoAppleFord.com. Offers with the credit and samples include all manufacturer offers and dealer discounts. See dealer for details. Offers expire 10/31/16.
Today it seems everybody's offering a discount on car insurance, but at what price? Reduced protection, personal service. At State Farm, you can earn discounts and still get full service and dependable protection. From the world's largest car insurer, see me, Trish Hauser, 1865 Susquehanna Trail North, York. For the State Farm Multiple Line Discount, with State Farm, you get an agent you can depend on and an insurance company you can trust. For the details on State Farm's Multiple Line Discount, see me, Trish Hauser.
Going to the dentist has never been on people's favorite things to do list. That's why Dr. Anthony Lupinetti goes out of his way to assure you and your family that we're a little different. Using the latest technology, Dr. Lupinetti is able to let you sit in luxury and comfort while he keeps your teeth and gums healthy. Welcome our new associate, Dr. Matt Green, a York Catholic grad. Open daily Monday through Friday. For an appointment, call 854-3310. For more info, visit springwooddental.com. Dr. Anthony Lupinetti, 2084 Spring Road, York.
To get ready for every Penn State football game, keep it on Sports Radio 1350. I'm Ron Ruman, and each week during the fall, I'll bring you the latest on Saturday's game with comments from Coach James Franklin and Nittany Lion players. Listen for reports throughout the day, Wednesdays through Fridays, to you by Penn State York, your neighborhood SureSafe Markets, and financial advisor Dave Sprinkle. For your Penn State football fix, stay tuned to Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Join me weekday mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
And back at York Catholic, Ron Ruman, Gareth Hissong here. The Vito's Pizza Halftime Show. We have a good one. The Irish 13, Bermudian Springs 7, battle for first place in Division 3. Time now for our Yorkness Bank Halftime Scoreboard Show. Another big win in D3 Littlestown, which is 3-1 in the division, lost to York Catholic. They lead Biglerville 20-7. The Bolts have the Eagles next week. That'll be when Dallastown can go to 7-1 overall. Big second quarter lead over New Oxford, 28-0. Gettysburg leading Daniel Boone in a non-league game, 33-7 in the second quarter. The DeLone Catholic Squires there, Gareth, 35-0 over Fairfield at the half. So Squires making a statement tonight. Eastern Leonardale 13-6 in the division contest. Redline going for its eighth straight win, leading Central in the second quarter, 21-6. Next week we'll be back in Division 1. Central at Dallastown. Join us for that one. At the half, Northeastern leading Spring Grove 14-0 as the Bobcats look to stay in contention in the division and also in the district playoff standings. In the second quarter, Susquehannock leading West York 14-7 in a battle of one-win teams. And at the half, Southwestern leading still winless York 14-0. And York Suburban looking to go to 6-2 overall. They lead Dover 16-6 at the half. That's our York Traditions Bank Halftime Scoreboard Show. Here it's 13-7, York Catholic leading Bermudian. Take a break, come back with our IACOS Coach's Pep Talk right after this.
My name is Bob Innerst. I'm a York Traditions Bank customer since 2008. One of the things that I like about York Traditions Bank is that I know everyone is right here in the York area and everybody's local and the decisions are made, you know, right here at the bank. So I feel very comfortable if I need a loan or if I have a question about anything, I'm going to get the answer from the people right here. Because we live here too means that they share a lot of the same concerns that I know that they give back to the local community, and it really makes a difference. They're invested here, and that's important to me. I now tend to measure other businesses that I deal with the level of service that I get at York Traditions Bank. I feel York Traditions Bank never takes my business for granted. I highly recommend York Traditions Bank to anyone.
Transition to traditions today. York Traditions Bank, member FDIC, equal opportunity lender.
Get your football parties started with great Best Yet products from your neighborhood SureSafe Markets. Pick up party planners with $18.93 deli items. Team up Best Yet hot dogs with Best Yet kettle cooked chips. And get Best Yet 12 packs of soda and Best Yet rising crust pizzas at Sauble's Markets in Shrewsbury, Stewartstown, Whiteford, and coming soon to East York at Nell's Markets Food in Spry and East Berlin and at Wetzel's in Glenrock.
Serving York County for 60 years, Jim's Auto Repair is your Napa Auto Care Center. Built on prompt, honest, and guaranteed service, Jim's Auto Repair does it all. Oil changes, state inspections, and tune-ups to helping your car last longer with regular maintenance. Schedule your appointment online at jimsautoyork.com or call 848-2749. That's 848-2749. Jim's Auto Repair, your key to great service. 108 East 11th Avenue, York.
There's only one place for local high school sports. Sports Radio 1350.
That is right, and we are here at York Catholic, and it's halftime. The Vito's Pizza Halftime Show, the Irish leading Bermudian 13-7. Time now for IACOS Coach's Pep Talk. All right, let's in the Irish locker room, and Eric DePue, what were they talking about, Gareth?
They want to stay sound on defense, continue with that defensive front doing a great job of eating up blocks and allowing linebackers to come in and clean up and stop the run game. But be weary and watch the deep throw over top. You don't want to give up any big plays when you've been hitting. on the defensive front and continue your dominance on offense, running right through the heart of the defensive front of Bermudian Springs.
All right, how about John Defoe and the Eagles?
It's been a trick-or-treat theme tonight with... We've had a team in, it was one trick play that kept Bermudian Springs in this ballgame with the throwback pass, 17-yard run for a touchdown. So Bermudian Springs has to continue to find ways to get the ball moving, as they had no success running between the tackles in the first half, as I mentioned, on their five offensive possessions, four three and outs. So they need to make plays on offense and get things going on the ground game.
All right, that's our year. Iaconos coach's pep talk here at halftime. A good one. York Catholic 13, Bermudian 7. The Maple Donuts third quarter comes your way next in the high school football game of the week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on Sports Radio 1350 and GameTimePA.com.
Penn State York. Great faculty, small classes, personal attention. Even if you're not sure what you want to do, Penn State York can help you choose the class, the course, the program, the certificate, seminar, or degree you want. Penn State York offers 9 4-year bachelor degrees you can complete without leaving the area. There are also 7 associate degrees. You can also begin the first 2 years of more than 160 Penn State majors right here in York. No matter what class you take, the national reputation of Penn State will follow you throughout your career. Call Penn State York for a brochure, 771-4040. That's 771-4040.
Hello, Maple Donuts.
Hello, it's me. Do you have baskets?
Did you say baskets?
Exactly. Look, I have a pretty good feeling. I'll be relocating soon in Washington.
Oh, sounds nice.
We're downsizing a bit. Little white house, big lawn, adorable. Anyway, what I need from Charlie is a good supply of Baker's Baskets.
Well, Maple Donuts offers a baker's dozen with every dozen Maple Donuts you buy.
You see, somebody has said she would put my supporters in a basket of delectables.
Yeah, no, I think she said a basket of
I know what she said, but I'm going to make this a positive.
I see.
I'm one of those champagne bottle half full kind of guys.
Is that right?
So, here's my plan. In my new home, I will place baskets of delectable Maple Donuts all around.
Oh, so any supporter who stops by could snack on a fresh, delectable Maple Donut. A glazed, a jelly-filled, vanilla sprinkles.
People love them.
Ooh, sounds like a big job. Who's going to be in charge of all those Maple Donuts?
People are suggesting the governor of New Jersey, but I'm thinking that might not be a good idea.
Yeah, the old fox in the hen house thing.
So sad. Maple Donuts taste.
Every day, Fast Science helps businesses like yours with their visual communication. We ask the right questions, recommend smart solutions, and help you build your business. Our knowledgeable consultants uncover your communication challenges and provide visible solutions. At Fast Signs, we're innovators, planners, and designers. We're more than fast, more than signs, and we're more than ready to help. Contact Fast Signs today.
This store next to Sam's Club in East York, or visit us online at fastsigns.com.
Your teams, all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350.
All right, we're back at York Catholic. Ron Ruhm and Gareth Hissong here, about ready to start the second half of Maple Donuts third quarter, and the Irish will receive. Gareth, we were talking during the break about whether, you know, you want to defer if you win that toss, you get the second half kick or the opener. I've always felt deferring is better. You get the choice of the second half, but you say there's some discussion now about getting that, maybe getting an extra possession if you take the opening kickoff.
It's not real popular, but there's a discrete theory now that if you receive first, you give yourself an opportunity to have one more extra possession in the ball game, and I see that a little bit, but you know, a lot of people don't have the type of offense where you can start the game fast. It takes a couple possessions for guys to get loose. So take the chance of getting the ball at second half. You got a little bit more experience of the opponent. You're a little bit more well-polished and see how the game's momentum has been. And it's certainly working out for the Irish here at York Catholic, as they've dominated most of the game. They have decided to make it interesting, though, by missing an extra point.
Yeah,
as they lead 13-7 here to start the third quarter.
And Noah Epley will boot it for a Fast Signs kick for Bermudian. If I was Bermudian, though, I'd love to get this second half kick because they got it in the end zone late there, so they have really some momentum. But the Irish will get it.
Well, it took a trick play for them to stay in this ball game so you don't come out with an onside kick.
Well, that's a thought. And Devin Hogden is right there. He's going to be taken off with the boot, and here it is. And they go deep, and it's going to be fielded at about the 18-yard line by one of the up men, and he is hit, taken out of bounds around the 32. As the Irish Antonio Staub on the return. And so the Irish will start in pretty good field, well, decent field position anyway. They had great field position on three of the first four possessions. But here they will start at their own. See where they spot this, their own 32-yard line.
As they did in the first half, they start the second half with the wind at their backs. Help them out in the passing game if they decide to go to the air.
Wide receiver each way for Yokimic on first down. He gives it to Kennard. Stead off right tackle, and Jakar is out for about 3 or 4 yards. Ryan Forsyth, a 6'1", 273-pound senior defensive tackle on the stop. And it's a gain of about 2 for Jakar, second and 8.
Offensively, the Irish in the first half had experienced a lot of success following the fullback, number 40, Carter Sinclair, up the middle, Kennard following his blocks.
And again, off the left side now, Jakar gets a hole. He's into the secondary. Man, he hits hard at the end of those plays. He is out to the 45-yard line. That is a gain of 11. And the stop made by Quentin Nace, but a gain of 11 and a first down for the Irish.
So multiple times tonight about this guy, Kennard, in the backfield. He finishes runs, uses his leverage, lowers the boom at the end of his runs.
Yokimic hands it to Kennard again, right up the middle, has another nice hole, cross midfield. He was smacked at the 48-yard line. Brenton Krebs got him high, and at the bottom of the pile is Darren Beal. That's a gain of 7. It's going to be second down and 3.
Every time he's carried the ball tonight and had an open space, only one time I've seen him get tackled and fall backwards instead of forwards. He's uses that leverage. He's got a lot of power, 175 pounds.
20 carries, 141 yards so far tonight, and he gets it again. Dancing in the backfield now, trying to get outside. Now cuts it back inside. The ball is loose. The ball is on the ground, and I think Bermudian got it before it went out of bounds. And yes, they did. Kennard got back to the line of scrimmage. It was knocked loose by Nace and recovered there, I think, by Ashton West. They're discussing whether he got it before. Yes, he did, before he went out of bounds. I think he did. I think that's a good call. And the Eagles have it on a first down on a turnover. First down at their own 47-yard line. Pick up at about the
47, first and 10. I think he got possession of that ball before the ball was out of bounds. Yep. But I think his body was out of bounds when he grabbed it. The way he slid and corralled the ball. Nevertheless, it's a first and 10 for the Bermudian Springs offense at the 47-yard line.
First turnover tonight, so we'll see what the Eagles can do. They trail at 13-7 here with 10:33 left in the Maple Donuts third. Off to Ashton West, the fullback straight ahead, and nothing there. He is shoved backwards, and now a flag flies late. There's no gain on the play, but a flag toward the end of that tackle. As Riley Brennan was the first guy in there. Matt Knauer was there, and a whole bunch of fellas, so see what the call is. The flag's lying at the 43-yard line. And the official will tell us, personal foul, face mask against the Irish, so that's going to be 15 yards and a first down for the Bermudian Springs Eagles. So as you mentioned, Gareth, the Irish really dominated the first half of play, but leading by just 6, and now on a turnover is Jakar Kennard fighting for extra yards, and a face mask penalty here. The Eagles first and 10 at the Irish 38.
Absolutely not a good start for the Irish in the second half. A turnover and a penalty. Had no penalties in the first half. Obviously no turnovers either. Bermudian Springs coming up with the momentum.
Chased all under center, first and 10. Pitches to Hogden, trying to get wide. He's hitting the backfield and dropped. Great tackle for the Irish by Daniel Kimmick. Yeah, who came up from his defensive back spot and met him in the backfield and dropped him for a 4-yard loss.
Daniel Kimmick, he's a senior. He's a 4-year starter. He played linebacker his first 2 years, They moved him back to the defensive back position. A lot of times they'll roll him up in the box as like another linebacker in that spot. That time he's able to come upfield, get the suplex tackle on the ball carrier.
Seventh tackle for loss this year for Yokemik, and it's second and 14 now for the Eagles of the Irish 42. And they fake the pitch now, and Dahl looking to throw. Nobody open, so he's going to run it. Ducks it, turns upfield, and gets down to the 35-yard line. Nice pull by Chase Dahl that time. Brought down by Adam Bittner. It's a gain of about seven. It's going to be third down and about 6.5, 7 for the Eagles at the Irish 35.
You can tell it was a major coaching point at halftime for this Irish defense to stay on your key, stay disciplined. Don't fall for the misdirection and the play fakes on the back side of this defense. Doing a great job of not letting receivers get past the defense.
Third and about six for the Eagles. The Irish 35-yard line now trying to take advantage of the turnover. Play fake, Dahl to throw. Has some time. Fires it deep down the middle. He's got a man open. It's Nace, but backing back there to break it up is Jakar Kennard. Almost picked off the interception. Nace was behind the defensive ball. Hung up a little bit too long, and Kennard able to get back there, much as Brendan Kennedy did in the first half, and break it up. It's going to be fourth down.
Great display of athleticism is Jakar Kennard. In a mental error in the coverage, you saw the communication with his teammates afterwards. As Brennan tried to, Kennedy tried to clear things up with Kennard. Kennard got beat deep, was able to recover and make the play on the ball, almost came up with an interception.
Well, it's fourth down. We have a physique punt. Devin Hogden is the punter, so you gotta watch for the fake. Of course, he's the running back. Here's the snap, and they do fake it. They snap it to Dahl. He set up the screen. Dahl gets it out, and he overshot Hogden. Oh, Hogden was hit late by Knauer, and there's the flag. Yes, indeed. Knauer hit Devin Hogden a good 2 to 3 seconds after the play was done, and he is going to get flagged, and that is a huge penalty because that was going to be Irish ball, and on the personal foul, that is going to give the Bermudian Springs Eagles a first down deep into Irish territory. And I was looking right at that one. No excuse for the junior, Matt Knauer, to make that late hit. The ball was on the ground. The play was dead for a good 2 to 3 counts. And Matt just nailed him.
Looks like we're going to walk it back in the Irish direction here. Let's see the official call.
I mean, that's how I saw it.
I didn't think it was incredibly egregious, but certainly a foul necessary to make that hit.
It's down to the 20, so at the Weckers Carpet red zone, first and 10 for the Bermudian Springs Eagles. So the Eagles have it on the huge personal foul penalty against the Irish. The Irish would have had it on downs, but now the Eagles threatening to tie or take the lead. They're down 13-7, 8:28 left in the Maple Donuts third. Ball at the Irish 20.
20-yard line.
Oh, they give it to, now it's Irish ball. Okay, Yokemik has it. That was after the play was dead. It was after the play was dead, so I guess that was a dead ball foul. So the Irish get it. My fault there, my mistake. And Yokemik on the carry. Gets out to the 31. It's a gain of 11. And a first down.
31-yard line for a York Catholic first and 10, ladies and gentlemen.
All right. So because it was a dead ball foul, the Irish got the ball. Yokemik takes it in the gun. Kennard straight ahead, and Jakar stopped after a short gain of a yard or two. Middle of that line is there. As Adam, Aaron Becker, the first guy to hit him. And gain of one for Kennard. It'll be second down and 9.
These Eagles have success on defense. They swarm to the ball. Use that team speed.
And fake to running back, and Yokemik fires it up the middle on a big hole out to the 46-yard line. And that is a gain of, targeted to 45. And that's a gain of 13. And Brenton Kretz on the stop, but a big hole in the middle of the line, and Yukemik gains 13 and moves the sticks for the Irish. Yukemik working from the gun, gives it to Kennard. Kennard straight up the middle, running hard, crosses midfield to the 49 of Bermudian Springs. That's going to be a gain of 6. It'll be second down and 4. Aaron Becker again on the stop for the Eagles.
Second down and 5 remaining.
This offensive front for York Catholic continue to have success, opening up lanes.
And Yukemik on the keeper, and he fights his way down to about the 46. He's going to be a yard or so short. Noah Epley on the stop for Bermudian, and there's a flag. That was actually marked at the 47, it looks, so it was a gain of 2, but we'll see what the penalty is. The officials talking it over. Personal foul against Bermudian. So that'll tack on 15, and it'll give the Irish a first down. And I think it's fair to say at this point, Mr. Hislong, it's getting a little chippy out there.
It is. That's the second personal foul for Bermudian in this game. Second personal foul in this half. One from each team.
So that's going to be marked off from the 47. That'll take it down to the 32-yard line, and the Irish will have a first and 10 there as they look to try and sustain the drive to perhaps build on their 13-7 lead with 6:49 left in the Maple Donuts third.
Not the fact that they're dirty, cheap shots, but it's good to see this chippiness. There's a rivalry here. Bermudian Springs have been the regents of this division for a while, and a lot of importance, postseason implications in this ball game.
Yukemik to Kennard, straight up the middle, and Ganjakar finishing that run, got down to the 28-yard line, a gain of 4. And Becker and Addison Wheeler on the stop, maybe second and 6.
And on top of the importance of this ball game and coming out with a win is just physicality. There's been a lot of hard hitting tonight on both sides, and that'll create some animosity.
On second and 6, play fake. Yukemik has it. He's down to the 25, and a flag flies around the end of the play. It would have been a gain of 3 and a third down and 3, but we'll see what the call is going to be.
Following a gain by Yukemik.
As the referee walks toward us, face masks against Bermudian, so that was not a personal foul. That's a 5-yarder, but that will still be enough for a first down, as that'll move it right to the, well, actually a little inside the 20 to about the 19, so inside the Weckers Carpet red zone, first and 10 for the York Catholic Fighting Irish.
Inside the 20, ladies and gentlemen.
And that gives Bermudian a tally of 5 penalties in this ball game to York Catholic's 2. York Catholic was clean, no penalty in the first half.
Yukemik out of the gun, hands it to Kennard off the right side, now dances back inside and gets a couple down to the Kennard 17.
The right
pretty well stacked up by the Eagles there as Ashton West is in there. And Noah Epley will be second down at about 8.
Ron, we talked about it a couple times that York Catholic dominated the first half with only a 13-7 lead to show for it. But it's been drives like this. We're approaching 3 minutes.
Play fake. Yukemik to throw. Stands in there. Fires for the end zone. Going for Sewell. And overshot him is tight end Ryan Sewell. Pretty good coverage down there. It was in the corner of the end zone. Quentin Nace was the defender. And it's going to be incomplete. It'll be third down and 8 for the Irish at the Bermudian Springs 17-yard line.
Ryan Sewell is the second favorite target for quarterback. Daniel Kitt comes into this game with 177 yards receiving, 5 receiving touchdowns. Nice to see the tight ends get utilized properly.
Always. third and 8. Big third down here for the Bermudian Springs defense. Yukemik on a delayed handoff to Kennard. Kennard straight up middle gets to the 15. The pile pushed forward to maybe the 14, but stacked up pretty well. Gain of only 2 to the 15. And Ashton West from his linebacker spot in the middle there with Noah Epley. So it's going to be fourth down and about 6 for the Irish.
But again, it hasn't been flash on offense for the Irish. It's been, they've traveled 4 yards over 3 minutes, and here they are with a 4th and 5 opportunity at the 15-yard line.
and then snap it over Yokemik's head. He'll go back and pick it up at the 35 and fires it toward the end zone. It is caught! Riley Brennan, are you kidding me? Dan Yokemik picks it up, ran all the way back to the 30, fired it right to the pylon, and Riley Brennan, the 6'3", 180-pound junior, climbed the ladder and made the catch, and the Irish lead it 19-7.
And that's a major asset you have when a quarterback is one of your best athletes. Stays calm under pressure. When there's chaos, he can still make plays and throws a nice strike downfield. Ryan Kennedy hauls in his touchdown of the season. Riley Brennan.
Irish going two now. Yokemik rolling and fires it in the end zone, and was he able to make it? Yes, he was. That's Brendan Kennedy. Kennedy with the PAT, the two-pointer. So with 4:52 left in the Maple Donuts third on the hook and play by Daniel Kemick, the Irish lead at 21-7. We're going to take a break. You're listening to the York Adams League High School Football Game of the Week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on Sports Radio 1350 and GameTimePA.com.
Unique Physique is your neighborhood gym in York. Young or old, it's the fitness center for you. Unique Physique has special classes for senior citizens like Zumba, Chair Yoga, and Silver and Fit Explore. Seniors, if your insurance has a Silver Sneakers or Silver and Fit plan, you can get a free membership at Unique Physique and two sessions with a trainer, also free. Achieve greater control of your health with physical activity and regular exercise. If you're looking for greater independence and a healthier life, call Don Kirchner at 755-2639.
Your county, your team. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports.
All right, we are back at York Catholic where the Irish, an exciting play. Great play by Daniel Kick and a great catch by Riley Brennan, taking the lead 21-7. We'll have a Fast Signs kick and then get our Yorktown Roofing and Siding scoring recap. And the Irish almost lost it on a personal foul on fourth down, but it was called a dead ball foul after the play had ended, so the Irish, the penalty was assessed, but the Irish kept the ball, and they were able to drive it down and get it into the end zone. So Bermudian in a position where they need to answer now because they're down two scores as we are more than halfway through the third. Boot by Basil and picked up at the 9-yard line by Crumruthen. He's to about the 35-yard line, so pretty nice return for Bermudian. That's Ryan Kerfman on the return. And Bermudian will set up first and 10 at its own 35. And let's get the Yorktown Roofing and Siding scoring recap.
Nice drive by York Catholic going six plays, 80 yards in 3 minutes, 28 seconds. And on a fourth and long, quarterback Daniel Kemick able to improvise. On a broken play, a snap goes over his head. He's able to scramble, get the ball, and still throw it 15 yards to Riley Brennan, who gets his third receiving touchdown of the year. York Catholic is up 21-7.
All right, Dahl under center now, takes the snap. Play fake and a throw, has a lot of time, and fires it for a man. He's got him, and that is Ben Eggenreiter. And it's a, no, they're saying he was out of bounds. Saying he was out of bounds. And so it's going to be second down and 10. Yeah, the official here on the sideline saying no good. Looked like he had caught it right on the sideline, but did not happen. So it's going to be second and 10.
It certainly looked like he was close, and we didn't have the best vision with the team standing right in front of us as the play was right in front of the bench. Around the 50-yard line. Meridian Springs moving from our left to right with 4 minutes, 38 seconds left in the third quarter. Trailing 21-7 has the ball at the 35-yard line at 2nd and 10.
That would have been a big play. It would have been a first down in Irish territory. It was a nice little touch pass all that time, but just out of bounds. So 2nd and 10. Dahl. Again, play fake, looking to throw. Good protection. Now the blitz comes. He got it off just before he was nailed. Jump ball. It's pulled in downfield by Trevor Kasulin, who went up over Jakar Kennard and pulled it down at the 28-yard line of York Catholic. That is a 37-yard completion by Chase Dahl on a first down for the Bermudian Springs Eagles. Trevor Hasulin.
So the Eagles will start first.
Great catch there as Trevor Kasulin made a huge catch. And that's his just his second catch of the year. He had a 28-yard touchdown reception last week. So the Eagles in business at the Irish 28, first and 10. And they give it off to West, and West is chopped down right at the line of scrimmage as a nice defensive play made by Jakar Kennard and Jake Hamilton. No gain. It's going to be second down and 10.
After that long catch, Trevor Kulin climbing a ladder. That's the kind of athletes you have at schools like this, guys that want to compete and make big plays like we saw. He's 6'6", 190 pounds is Kasuli. He went up and made that play over Jakar Kennard. Kennard seems a little shaken up after that play, but continues to stay on the field.
Second 10 at the 20-yard line, and Dahl to throw. A lot of time again. Now Bittner chasing him, and he gets away from Bittner, but is going to be dragged down right about the line of scrimmage. Jake Hamilton will bring him down. That was a coverage, right at the line of scrimmage, so not really a sack, but he had a lot of time, could find no one open, and so it's going to be third down and 10 from the Irish 28.
Yeah, two kinds of sacks. Opportunity sacks, effort sacks. And that was an opportunity sack there. Great coverage downfield on the backside. Again, I said it was a major coaching point at halftime not to let these receivers take the top off the defense and get behind the coverage.
All right, you got Kasulin out there on Matt Brewer. Kasulin at 6'6", Brewer at 5'9". See if they look that way. Dahl, fade to throw, fires it out there and into a crowd, and it is picked. It is intercepted by the Irish.
And from the Irish receiver, ladies and gentlemen, that will be an interception by your fighting Irish.
I couldn't pick up the number.
Daniel Yochemic loves the ball so much when it's quarterback.
Yochemic on the pick as that one was thrown into a crowd by Chase Dahl, and the Irish are going to have it first and 10 just outside their own 20-yard line, it does look like.
We've seen that year in and year out. Danny Yochemic making big plays on both sides of the ball. He can play linebacker, defensive back, wide receiver, running back, quarterback. What a utility player.
Third interception of the year for Yochemic, and that was huge because Bermudian was on the move. And Kennard gets it, looking to bust outside. Flag flies as Kennard got about a yard, and that's it. As Quentin Nace and Trevor Grimm combined on the stop for what would have been a one-yard gain, but we'll see what the call is. It's a hold against the Irish, so that's going to move them back deep in their own territory. 2:35 left in the Maple Donuts third. Irish up by two scores, but Bermudian now with an opportunity to keep the Irish, if they can, bottled up here in their own end and perhaps get the ball in good field position. But the Irish offense has been on fire most of the night.
They have, and it's been slow, methodical drives, keeping it on the ground, running between the tackles. The Irish have put the ball on the turf three times tonight, lost it once. The Eagles have to stay aggressive and try to get a turnover.
Ball back at the 11. It's first and 20 from there for the Irish. And Yochemic is going to run. It has a hole and cuts to the near side and is out to about the 20-yard line before he is stopped there. Quentin Nace on the stop. Got about 10 back to the 21. It'll be second down and 10 from there.
Eagles trying to guess with the blitz, bringing pressure up the middle in the A gaps. Fortunately for the Irish, they run it the other way. Yochemic has a nice running lane, and they're set up at second and 10.
Yochemic out of the gun. Looks delayed. Quarterback draw, and he gets about a yard. Pretty good tackle that time. That is Ashton West. He's been active defensively tonight. 5'7", 170-pound senior linebacker. Their leading tackler at 8 a game. He brought Yochemic down after a gain of 1. It's going to be 3rd and 9 for the Irish from their 22.
The Irish trying to spread out the defense for Bermudian. Haven't seen that a lot tonight where they go 5 receivers. Yochemic in the backfield by his lonesome. They've had more success with a fullback in the backfield tonight.
Yochemic out of the gun, wide receiver each way, looking to throw, roll his left now, steps up, fires it deep down the middle for Brendan Kennedy, who makes the grab. Oh, nice catch by Kennedy, brought down by Brenton Tripp, but at the 30. 39-yard line of Bermudian Springs, and that is a 39-yard pass completion from Yokemik to Brendan Kennedy, and the Irish are in business at the Eagle 39-yard line.
Kennedy able to showcase his athletic ability, and we can certainly see how he came up with 200 yards receiving last week against Biglerville. Outstretched arms, hauls it in, nice catch.
And Kennedy's 24th catch of the season. Here's Kennard now. Big hole up the middle. Kennard into the secondary at the 20. Makes a cut to the outside. Inside the 10. Sheds another tackler. And he is into the end zone. Ryan Kennard, 39 yards. And the Irish are on the verge of breaking this one open. 27-7 with 54 seconds left in the third.
We've seen Kennard run up the middle. We've seen him lower the boom. We've seen him make moves and get around guys. This time, he does it again. Some jukes, gets on the perimeter, and gets his third rushing touchdown tonight.
All right, so Bermudian was on the move, but the interception by Dan Yokemik at the Irish 21-yard line stopped that drive, and the Irish taking advantage of the turnover to go up by 20 here, pending the extra point attempt.
Dormer and Basil?
Yeah.
By Nick Basil.
Dormer on the hold for Basil for the point after.
Snap is there, the set is down, flag flies, so the kick went through, but we'll see what the call is, illegal procedure against the Irish, so they'll have to move it back five, and that will make it a 25-yard extra point attempt.
It's over again from 5 yards deeper.
Kennard, been a lot of fun to watch tonight. Him and Yokemik, been the bell cows for this Irish offense.
Yep. So this will be set at the 15, and Basil will have to boot it through from there.
Who's our center on these
ones? Snap is there, a little low, but Dormer gets it down. Kick is up, and it didn't make it, just short. So the Irish missed the PAT, and Basil kind of limped toward the sidelines a little bit with the right leg. So we'll see about that. 4 seconds left of the Maple Donuts third. Irish 27, Eagles 7. Take a break on the High School Football Game of the Week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine.
If you're buying flooring, besides clicking around the internet, you need the Weckers Flooring Center. You'll be excited by Weckers' new design center for luxury vinyl tile. Weckers' expanded hardwood and laminate departments will impress you. And Weckers' variety of carpeting and warehouse truckload buys on remnants and rolls is unmatched. But the reason to choose Weckers is trust. From the buying experience to the installation, that's why they're voted best 11 years running. Weckers Flooring Center, Route 30, Hellam Exit.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Join me weekday mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Big money.
The Irish go up 27-7 on the electric run by Jakar Kennard, and they've got Bermudian on the ropes right now with just 54 seconds left in the third quarter. We'll have a fast signs kick, and Basil is out there, so trying to walk it off. Looked like a little bit of an ankle issue for him, but he will boot it, and then we'll get our Yorktown Roofing and Siding scoring recap. The Irish taking advantage of the interception by Yokemik to halt their Bermudian drive, and taking it down and scoring at the other end.
Someone take it 6-9.
It's the turnovers and the special teams where Bermudian had shine tonight to come out on top because of the dominance we've seen from this Irish team.
And so Basil will approach the ball and get our fast signs kick here, and he does, looking all right there. Bounces at the 15, it goes past the receiver and into the end zone, and so it's going to be a touchback, and Bermudian will have it first and 10 at the 20-yard line. So let's get our scoring recap from Yorktown Roofing and Siding.
Most impressive drive York Catholic has had tonight. 4 plays, 79 yards, and Jakar Kennard breaks loose on a 39-yard touchdown run for his third rushing touchdown of the night, 10th of the season. With 54 seconds left in the third quarter, York Catholic has a commanding lead, 27, Bermudian Springs 7.
All right, we'll see if the Eagles throw caution to the wind and start putting it up here as they're down by 20. Here, a run run heavy offense, but they may have to throw it out. Dahl under center, and they're going to hand it off, and they give it to West. Ashton West out to the 26 is hit by Yokemic out there. And also
Yokemic all over on
Ryan Sewell. It's a gain of 6 to the 26, so it'll be second down and 4 for the Eagles.
Second down.
Carr Kennard is
second down
on the sidelines, on the bench, getting stretched out. Seems like he landed awkward after going up to contest a pass in their last defensive possession.
And I want to keep him healthy, that's for sure. He's normally in there at defensive back, but they're stretching the right leg right now. Second and 4 for the Eagles, and they give it off in the backfield to West again, and Ryan Sewell again on the stop. Gain of about 2. It'll be third down and 2. Adam Bittner also there for the Irish. And that's the end of 3, so we have played 3, and York Catholic with the late touchdown up 20. We head to the York Mitsubishi fourth quarter. York Catholic 27, Bermudian 7, the high school football game of the week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on Sports Radio 1350 and GameTimePA.com.
Yorktown Roofing and Siding, locally owned and operated since 1992. Premier building materials distributor in Central PA. Distributors from siding, windows and doors, ding and railing, seamless gutter and gutter guard, and cabinets and vanities. Both wholesale and retail. Located at 261 Northeast Street in York. Online at YorktownRoofingandSiding.com. Or call 845-9447 or toll free at 1-800-457-3943.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Irish up 20 after 3 here in the battle for first place in Division 1, in Division 3. Up in Division 1, Dallastown leading New Oxford 41-0, so they will go to 7-1 and stay only a game behind Redland. The Lions leading Central 21-12. That's assuming the Lions hang on, so the Panthers giving them a game there. Big one in Division 1, and also Northeastern Spring Grove 27-0 to hang in that division race. Third and 2, and they hand it off in a big hole off the left side, and out to the 35-yard line goes Ashton West, for he is stopped by Matt Brewer, Yokemic, and Bittner. That's a gain of 9 and a first down for the Bermudian Springs Eagles. Other scores on our Browns Orchards and Farm Market scoreboard update. Littlestown hanging in the D3 race. They're only lost to York Catholic. They're up on Bicklerville 33-7 in the fourth. And DeLone leading Fairfield 45-0. So the Squires about to get their second league win. Eastern looking to stay pace with Suburban and D2, leading Kennerdale 19-6 in the fourth. First and 10 here for Bermudian at their own 35. Egan Ryder in motion from us. And Dahl drops to throw, but penalty flag at the snap. Illegal procedure against Bermudian. Northeastern leading Spring Grove 27-0, so the Bobcats big over the Rockets, and they will look to move their record to 6-2 overall. At the half, Susquehanna leading West York 14-7, Division 2, Southwestern 14. York 9-0 at 4. Bearcats still winless in Suburban with a 3-point 16-13 lead over the Dover Eagles, hanging tough. Right now Suburban in first place in Division 2, so we'll see what happens there. And that's your Browns Orton Farm Market scoreboard update. At the 30, first and 15 for the Bermudian Springs Eagles. Counter play to Devin Hogden, and he is nailed in the gap after about a 2-yard gain. And making the hit there was Carter Sinclair, I believe, the linebacker, after the 2-yard gain, and it's going to be second down and about 13. Yokemic may have made the hit there. Yokemic and Carter filled the hole well. Ball at the Eagle 32 now, and just 10:35 left in the York Mitsubishi fourth, and Eagles down 20. Dahl on second and long, under center. Man in motion and gives it off to West. No, they're going to throw. Dahl on a play fake and fires it out to West and missed him. Missed him on the fat there. He was open. Would have been probably a 5 or 6 yard gain, but incomplete. So going to lead the Eagles with a 3rd and 13. Hampton, I think, and the linebacker got a hand on that one for the Irish.
Chase Dahl rolling out to his right with the waggle pass. As you mentioned, wide open receiver in the flat. Again, good defense from this Irish team, and
once again, ladies and gentlemen,
continue to make plays, stifle the offense for the Eagles.
So it's 3rd and 13, and the Bermudian in dire need of a conversion to keep any chance of hope alive in this one. If the Irish hang on, they will go to 7-1 and 5-0 in the league, and that will be huge, beating a Triple-A team for their Double-A playoff standings as well. They are just percentage points ahead of Newport right now, and they give it to Hogden. Hogden's going to throw on the halfback option, fires it deep downfield, and it is pulled out of there by Nace, but then he dropped it as he took it away from Kennard at the top of the jump, but as he was going to the ground, unable to bring it in, Quentin Nace. So good try by the Eagles, but it doesn't work, and it's going to be 4th and 13 in a unique physique punt.
Did a couple to second half that it was a major coaching point at halftime. Be sure you stay at home. Do your job. Trust your teammates that they'll do theirs. Stay on your keys. And this defensive coverage tonight has been great in the second half. Haven't let the receivers get past the coverage. Another great play by Kennard.
Devin Hogden to punt. Good snap. He gets it off. High kick. Good punt by Hogden over Montez's head. Hits at the 22. And bounces inside the 15 to the 14. Nice punt by Devin Hogden. But the Irish will have it at their 14 with 10:04 left in the York Mitsubishi fourth quarter, and the Irish needing it by 20.
The way this offense has controlled the time of possession all night, they'll have no issue with this commanding lead up 20 with 10 minutes and 4 seconds left on the clock. Ball on their own 15 to run this clock out. Take 3-4 minutes off the clock. Keep the ball on the ground and leave little hope for the Eagles.
Yeah, I'm sure that's the plan right now. Just grind this baby out. And Yokemik will work out of the gun. Kennard is in there. You've seen him working on the right leg tonight, but and Bermudian jumps, the whole defensive line jumps, so the hard kick got him there, and the Irish will get 5 on the penalty.
Offsides on the Eagles.
So they will move it 5 up to about the 19-yard line. It'll be 1st and 5 from there.
Walk off 5 yards.
Most everything's gone. The Irish's way tonight. I don't know if it's just the luck of the Irish or what, but 7 penalties against the Eagles and only 2.
Kennard off left tackle and moves it forward near the 25-yard line. In fact, he got the 25, got the 26. Then to be a first down and a gain of 6, and the Irish will move the sticks. And the stop was made there by Addison Wheeler, but 6-yard gain for Jakar Kennard, who's been a workhorse tonight. 28 carries tonight for Kennard.
Name we don't mention often enough is Carter Sinclair, the fullback, who has made great blocks all night, pairing up these linebackers from Bermudian.
1st and 10 at the 26 now. 9:30 left in the York Mitsubishi fourth. Yokemik waits till the back judge raises his hand. There's no 5 seconds on the play clock. Gives it off to Kennard straight up the middle, and
Kennard looking for a running room.
Dropped at about the 7 or 28-yard line.
Gain of 4 on the play, second down.
And moves it out to the 29. It's a gain of about 3, and it'll be 2nd and 7 from there.
Brendan Krebs on the tackle for the Eagles.
Yep, Brendan Krebs made the stop there from the defensive back spot. 2nd and 7 at the 29 now, and the Irish will milk this clock for all they can, down to 8:50.
This offensive line, not small themselves, but had a tall task going up against a defensive.
Done a good job tonight, though. Kennard gets a big hole on the right side. Kennard at the 40. He's at the 50, and they, I don't believe they're going to catch him. Hogden is chasing him, but he is inside the 10 and into the end zone. Jakar Kennard, 71 yards into the end zone, and that should seal it for the Irish. They go 33-7.
Kennard, we've seen how hard he's run tonight, lowering the boom on defenders. But anytime he gets some open green, he can bust it loose. We saw for a 39-yard touchdown earlier in this one, but for 70 yards in his fourth rushing touchdown on the night.
All right, we'll try and get his total during the break. It's going to be a lot to add up. As it looks like the Irish may go for two. I'm not sure that Nick Basil, their kicker, is feeling all that well. He looked like he had a right ankle issue. So it's 33-7 with 8:32 left in the fourth quarter. And the Irish on the verge of going to 7-1 on the season and 5-0 and put themselves in the driver's seat for D3. And the Irish have to take a timeout right now. So. Well, if you're ready to do the Yorktown roofing and scoring recap, I'll add up Kennard's rushing yards tonight.
In a minute 36 seconds, only two plays as the Irish attempt to keep the ball on the ground and run the clock out. They do one better, take it for 1 yard and a dagger of a touchdown. They lead right now 33-7, pending a two-point conversion. And it's been a heavy dose of Jakar Kennard tonight.
I have him unofficially with 272 yards on the night on 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 carries for 272 for Jakar Kennard. That's a heck of a night.
He's due for some accolades at the end of the season.
Yep. So the Irish will go for two now. I think just again, I think their kicker's not.
Not officially. Are those more? Is that still more accurate than these presidential polls we see?
I don't know. The polls are pretty scientific. I think they're probably right. Play fake. Yokemi rolling right. Going to keep it and get into the corner of the end zone. So Dan Yokemi on the 2-point PAT. The Irish lead at 35-7. 32 left. On the football game, presented by Wells Fan Sports Medicine on Sports Radio 1350 and Game 10 PA.
Sports injury? Walk into WellSpan Urgent Orthopedics for immediate care. No appointment is ever needed. Our orthopedic and sports medicine specialists are here to treat you. WellSpan.org/orthopedics today for hours at our York and Hanover locations.
It's time again for York Mitsubishi's annual fall sales event. Collection of 2016's in stock, saved like never before on all remaining Outlanders, Outlander Sports, Lancers, and Mirages. Rebates and discounts up to $4,000 or financing as low as 0% for 72 months. All cars are priced to sell, so now's the time. And as always, every new Mitsubishi gets our famous 10-year, 100,000-mile powertrain limit warranty. So stop by York Mitsubishi's annual fall sales event and see what we can do for you. York Mitsubishi, just off Route 30 on Roosevelt Avenue, York.
The home for local sports. Sports Radio 1350, WOIK.
All right, we are back at York Catholic, and the party has started here on the home side as the Irish are up 35-7 in this big one for Division III. Both teams coming in at 4-0 in the division and 6-1 overall. But the Irish, I think, making a statement here tonight, Gareth, as they've really put it to a pretty decent Bermudian Springs team.
Yep, not many tricks, mostly a treat for this home crowd. A couple of mixed extra points, able to overcome that adversity. We saw that last position. Last two-point try, Daniel Kemick rolls out on a naked boot, scrambles in for two. They lead by 8.
And out of the Jake Hamilton hold, Basil's kick goes along the ground and is picked up by Brenton Krebs at about the 25-yard line. And Krebs out to the 33 or 34 before he is wrapped up and taken down out there for the Irish. And the special teams play made by Jared Cole for the Irish. So Bermudian now in a huge hole, and they'll probably have to come out throwing as they are down by 28 with just 25 left.
And we really didn't expect this kind of onslaught tonight. This Irish team, we knew they were good. Bermudian comes in with a good record. Only one loss to a good Shippensburg team. They've handled everyone else.
Yeah. That's right, and Chip is 7-0, and they're the two seed in Quad A right behind Berks Catholic, the team that beat York Catholic 34-0. So, wow, the Berks Catholic must have a squad and a half. Dull under center at the 33, and first down they give it off to Brenton Krebs, who breaks through and is out to the 49-yard line before they finally get him around the ankles. Riley Brennan on the stop, but a gain of 16 yards for Brenton Krebs and a first down for the Bermudian Springs Eagles.
Bermudian's program has such sustained success running this wing T offense. We often talk about how difficult it is to prepare for that style of offense, but really you're starting to see it, well, in this league you see it a lot. Cologne Catholic,
yeah.
York Catholic, Salt, Berks Catholic runs that style offense.
Dahl under center now on first and 10, puts Egan Ryder in motion, and they give it off to Krebs, and nothing doing this time as he went right at the line of scrimmage by big Liam Landis, spun away for a moment, but just got back to the line of scrimmage, and it'll be second down and 10 from there.
Defensively, when you face that wing T style, it's certainly makes you read your keys a little bit more, takes away from some of the natural, just the reactions you want to have on defense and not have to think as much, but makes you more disciplined. But it's the same fundamental keys: get upfield, gap integrity, and tackle well.
Second and 10 at the Eagle 49-yard line. They hand it off to Addison Wheeler, who's hit in the backfield by Ryan Sewell, who makes his 12th tackle for loss of this season. It's a loss of 2 to the 47, and it is going to be third down. Well, loss of 1 to the 48. It'll be third down and 11.
We've seen that recipe illustrated from this defense all night. Even on that last play, defense does a great job of getting upfield, set the edge, force the ball carriers inside to where the defensive help is coming. Good team defense from this Irish defensive unit.
So third down and 11 for Bermudian at their own 48, clock at 6:40 in the fourth quarter, and Irish leading by 28. And Dahl hands it off, and oh, is Brenton Krebs nailed by Ryan Sewell at the line of scrimmage. Talk about a linebacker filling the hole. He did that and then some, and it's going to be fourth down and most likely, excuse me, a unique physique punt.
Another monster mash hit from this Irish physical defense. They continue to pop the pads.
Breaks up the play enough for a first and 10 Irish. Recovery of fumble, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, the Irish, they said there was a fumble. I didn't even see the ball come out there, so the Irish recovered a fumble. I completely missed that at the bottom of the pile, and the hit by Sewell jarred it loose. So the Irish at the Eagle 48, first and 10. Yokemik going to throw. Rolling to his right, fires it, and at the sideline was the catch made by Sewell. It was at the 38-yard line, and so that's a gain of 10 and enough for a first down. So the Irish with the big lead here coming out throwing.
And back to that turnover. Ryan Sewell really was the epitome of a jarring hit. Perfect form tackle. Gets ball loose, and York Catholic stays aggressive and keeps the pedal down on offense as they go to the air on the first play. Sets them up with a second and one from the 28-yard line.
So Yokemik will go from the gun again, out of bounds, stop the clock, 6:02 left. Yokemik hands it off to Kyle Dormer at the tailback spot now, and Dormer, a nice hole, but a flag at the end of the play. Dormer had it down to the 34, would have been a gain of 5 and a first down, but a hold against the Irish will wipe that one out. So Kyle Dormer is giving the rest of the night off to Jakar Kennard, who's had a heck of a night, unofficially 30 carries, 272 yards and 4 touchdowns. Here is the clock strikes 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK York. First in York, first in sports. And the penalty in the Irish will move it back to their side of the field, to the 48. And from there, it will be second down and about 14.
Talked about the play of this defense from the Irish and how that's helped them be so successful tonight. But a lot of other things went their way as well, as they've only had 3 penalties to all coming in the second half, as opposed to the 7 from Bermudian Springs. And the field position battle certainly won by the Irish.
And Yokemik takes up. He's going to throw again. Kind of surprised the Irish are throwing with the lead. And they get a little bubble screen here to Riley Brennan, who gets a gain of about 5 before he is gang tackled, and leave the Irish with about a 3rd and 9 from the Eagle 47-48 yard line.
Having a gain on the play takes us back to the original Playing image and then some. Third down and nine on the play.
Brennan's second catch tonight for 20 yards. Third and nine for the Irish at Eagle 47-yard line.
It's been a physical game between the lines. Game full of animus and certainly no love lost when the coaching strategy is the Irish stay aggressive and continue to work their craft and go to the air.
Yokemik again waiting for the back judge to put his hand up. 5 seconds on the play clock, takes the snap, and a delayed handoff to Dormer. Dormer hit in the backfield and dropped for about a 3-yard loss. Good defensive penetration that time by a Bermudian, and Kyle will end up losing about 3 on the play. So it's going to be fourth down and a unique physique punt from Jordan Robbins.
Fourth down and 12. From the 50-yard line.
So we're down 4:20 left here in the York Mitsubishi fourth quarter, and Jordan Williams will put it for the Irish.
With a stiff wind in his face.
And a snap floats back there, and he gets it away, almost blocked, but he gets it off, and it's going to go out of bounds around the 25-yard line. And Bean will take over down 35-7 with 4:03 remaining in the football game.
Defender might have gotten a hand on that punt. Help out Bermudian a little bit, get a little bit better. They'll start on the 24-yard line. So they can get something going on offense.
Don't forget to bring your
so far tonight, stifled by the Fighting Irish.
And Bermudian's got one next week. They have little, so they need to. They'll need to lick their wounds, recover, and then get ready for another tough one next week. They're still going to be alive in the play hunt for AAA.
Friday, November 4th.
Dahl undertakes the snap, hands it off, and straight up the middle goes Brenton Krebs and Adam Bittner jousting with him there at about the 28-yard line. It'll be a gain of 4, and it'll be second down and 6 from there. And the Irish, you know, if they can finish as the top seed in the districts, they will get the district championship game because they're only 2 in AA. They will be here on the Irish field. Their higher seed gets that home game.
Certainly see the benefits of home tonight. This crowd been charged up.
Second down and about 6 for the Eagles. And they hand it off to Addison Wheeler around the right side. Good hole, and Wheeler's going to have a first down before you. Shoved out of bounds, across the way by Brent Kennedy, out to the 40-yard line, and that's a gain of 12. So nice run there by Addison Wheeler, and moves the sticks for the Eagles.
I'm sure when folks from around the league, this will be a big score.
Yeah.
We see the outcome of this contest.
10 at the 40. Mandel under center now. 3:16 left. And they hand it straight ahead, and a nice run out to the 48-yard line by Brenton Krebs. Carter Sinclair and Riley Brennan on the stops. And it's going to be a gain of 7. It'll be second down and 3.
About 7 yards on the play, so we'll call it down a long 3.
And again, kudos to the guys in the trenches for the Fighting Irish. Bermudian Springs offensive line goes 273, 225, 262, 210, 225. That's a tall task for this Irish front, and they've been up to it.
Second and 3, and they get it to, I believe that's Wheeler, down to the Irish 40-yard line.
This time another carry into Fighting Irish.
Trying to pick up the number, I believe it was Addison Wheeler, and it was. It's a nice gain of 13 for Addison Wheeler, and moves the sticks to the Irish 40. But we're down to 2.5 minutes left in the game. Not in doubt, the Irish going to go to 7-1 on the year. Dahl under center, clock down to 2:20 now. And the sophomore quarterback takes the snap and hands it to Brenton Krebs off the right side and keeps the legs churning, gets down to about now. We're going to have some extra curricular. We're going to have a flag as Nick Anzalone and Ben Eigenrider were tangled up afterwards, so we'll see what happens here. It was a 4-yard gain for Krebs before the penalty here. 2:06 left. And it's going to go against Bermudian.
Anzalone there for the ailing. Jakar Kennard. One of the guys they bring in that's a backfield.
So the personal foul will be a big 15-yarder against the Eagles. They've had some penalty issues tonight, back to their own 49, and from there it's going to be first down and 21.
Eighth penalty of the night.
Second warning.
Third personal foul.
We can't remind you enough, ladies and gentlemen, for that phone call, that text, until you get
to have a timeout taken here by the Fighting Irish. I think they just want to make sure nobody loses his head and gets tossed, because anybody gets tossed here at the end, they can't play next, so you don't want that. We'll take a break. The Irish up 35-7 on Sport Radio 1350, GameTimePA.com.
When you need a haircut, where do you go? If you need a hair replacement, who's the expert? When barbers need a haircut, where do they go? The answer is Iaconos, of course. The most interesting barbers in York. Don't normally get a shave? Go to Iaconos. They'll take care of you. Need a facial? That's right. Iaconos is to get it done. Iaconos, the most interesting barbers in York. They do it all. For an appointment, call 854-8258. That's 854-8258.
First in York, first in sports. Sports Radio 1350,
WOIK. And out of the timeout, Bermudian with it now. First and 21, back of their own 49 with just 2:06 left. And they hand it off to Addison Wheeler off the right side. Wheeler running hard, breaks a couple of tackles, and gets down to the Irish 40-yard line. Gain of 11, nice run by Wheeler. Jared Cole on the stop. Gain of 11, and it'll be second down and 10 from there.
15-yard infraction.
And let's check some scores here. And Central has scored. They have cut the red line lead to 2, 21-19 in the fourth quarter, and a big win in Division One. Our scoreboard update from Brown's Orchards and Farm Markets, so we'll keep an eye on that one. Dallas Town 48-6 over New Oxford, so the Wildcats will go to 7-1. And they hand it off to Addison Wheeler again on the right side. Addison picking his way down the far sideline is forced out of bounds around the 30-yard line, just shy of it. So it looks like it's going to be third down and one from the 31-yard line.
Have a gain on the play, but just shy of a first down for the Eagles. Looks like they'll line up.
It's fourth down. Now fourth, and I thought it was third. It's fourth down and short, and Northeastern's defeated Spring Grove 27-0. So the Bobcats go to 6-2. Fourth and short, and they're going to give it off. And, boy, it's going to be close. I believe that was Krebb, and he's right at the 30, so we'll have to see where they mark this. And I think he's got enough for the first down, and he does. Brenton Krebs got one and moved to 6. Eastern's defeated Kennedale 26. Suburban leading Dover 23-13 in the fourth. Now so Suburban looking to stay on top of 2. Susky leading West York 21-14 in the fourth. Southwest 28. York High 13 in the fourth. And DeLona 35-0 win over Fairfield tonight. And here they give it to Wheeler. Wheeler around the right side. Addison cuts it up and down to about the 24 lines. Gain of 6. Sinclair stopped along with Anzalone. He'll be second and four. And what else do we have? Sarstown defeats Biglerville 33-14. So that's your scoreboard update from Brown's Orchards and Farm Market. We'll check in Redline and Central again in a few.
You mentioned that Spring Grove loss. They had a tough year. That program will rebound. Sprinkle. Coach Sprinkle's done good things there.
Puts them down to 4-4 now. And Krebs dancing in the backfield, then breaks through down to the 15-yard into the Weckers red zone. Kyle Dorr on the stop, but a nice run, 9-yard gain by Brenton Krebs here, who's racking up some stats late. 25 seconds left in the game, and Bermudian going to try and get a play or two off here. So they're down 35-7, playing for pride at the moment. And Chase Dahl under center and gives it off to Wheeler. Wheeler off the right side, and Addison picks up about 3. It'll be second and 7, and if they don't stop the clock, that's probably going to do it for down to 7 seconds. And that will be it. There's your final. York Catholic 35 and Bermudian Springs 7 in a statement win for the Fighting Irish. And they move to 7-1 and 5-0 in the league. Take a break. Come back with a Penn State York game show after this on Sports Radio 1350 and Game Time PA, the high school football game of the week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine.
Penn State York. Great faculty. Small classes. Personal attention. Even if you're not sure what you want to do, Penn State York can help you choose the class, the course, the program, the certificate, seminar, or degree you want. Penn State York offers 9 four-year bachelor degrees you can complete without leaving the area. There are also 7 associate degrees. You can also begin the first 2 years of more than 160 Penn State majors right here in York. No matter what class you take, the national reputation of Penn State will follow you throughout your career. Call Penn State York for a brochure, 771-4040. That's 771-4040.
Hello, Maple Donuts.
Hello, it's me. Do you have baskets?
Did you say baskets?
Exactly. Look, I have a pretty good feeling. I'll be relocating soon in Washington.
Oh, sounds nice.
We're downsizing a bit. Little white house, big lawn, adorable. Anyway, what I need from Charlie is a good supply of Baker's Baskets.
Well, Maple Donuts offers a Baker's Dozen with every dozen Maple Donuts you buy.
You see, somebody has said she would put my supporters in a bed of delectables.
Yeah, no, I think she said a basket of
I know what she said, but I'm going to make this a positive.
I see.
I'm one of those champagne will have full kind of guys.
Is that right?
So, here's my plan. In my new home, I will place baskets of delectable Maple Donuts all around.
Oh, so any supporter who stops by could snack on a fresh, delectable Maple Donut. A glazed, a jelly-filled, vanilla sprinkles.
People love them.
Sounds like a big job. Who's going to be in charge of all those Maple Donuts?
People are suggesting the governor of New Jersey, but I'm thinking that might not be a good idea.
Yeah, the old fox in the hen house thing.
So sad. Maple Donuts
taste right. Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
All right, back here at York Camp as the home fans are happy. The Irish celebrate 35-7 win over Bermudian Springs in the battle for first place in Division 3, which the Irish have convincingly taken now with wins over Littlestown a couple weeks ago and then tonight over Bermudian. So the Irish 5-0 and 7-1. And let's get our Yorktown Roofing and Siding scoring cap from the game with Gareth.
It was a very impressive win tonight. York Catholic dominated this ball game, and it started on their second possession, going 5 plays, 47 yards, finished with a 1-yard touchdown run. Jakar Kennard, who had a night, with 2 minutes, 4 seconds left in the first quarter, York Catholic went up 7-0 over Bermudian. And 2 possessions later, they go 3 plays, 51 yards, finish again with a 1-yard touchdown run from Jakar Kennard. And that gave him his 9th rushing touchdown on the season with 4 minutes, 46 seconds before halftime after a missed point after attempt. York Catholic took the lead, 13, Bermudian 0. Bermudian answered on the ensuing action with a 7-play, 32-yard drive, and they were set up in that great field position thanks to a nice kickoff return and finished on a 4th and long, a throwback pass. And Devin Hogden took 17 yards to pay dirt with 32 seconds left before half. Our halftime score was York Catholic 13, Bermudian Springs 7. And after that, the second half was all the Irish. On their first offensive possession, had a turnover, got the ball back after a stop on defense, and goes 6 plays, 80 yards, with a 15-yard touchdown pass. Daniel Kemick, on a broken play, improvises and finds his wide receiver, Riley Brennan, downfield, who scrambles in for a touchdown. And after a 2-point conversion, hauled in by Brendan Kennedy, York Catholic took the lead with 4 minutes, 52 seconds left in the third quarter, 21. Bermudian Springs 7 on their next possession. At the end of the third quarter, they go 4 plays, 79 yards. After he breaks loose, Jakar Kennard, a 39-yard touchdown run. And with 54 seconds left in the third quarter, after another missed PAT, York Catholic took the lead by 27-7 in the fourth quarter. And the last score of our game, a 2-play drive, finished with another Jakar Kennard getting loose, 71 yards. Gave him his 11th rushing touchdown of the season, fourth of the night. And with 8 minutes, 32 seconds left in the ballgame, gave us our final score, York Catholic 35, Bermudian Springs 7.
All right, good job by you, Gareth. And a statement win by the Irish tonight, 35-7, as they take control of Division 3 and should stay in the top spot. Out of three, take a break with a Cup and Kunkel. Final stats after this.
Brown's Orchards and Farm Market in Loganville was built on teamwork, commitment, and passion. For over 65 years, Brown's has been a delicious destination for hand-picked fruits and award-winning bakery treats. As we celebrate football season, make Brown's Catering your tailgating headquarters for barbecue, party trays, wings, steamed shrimp, giant 2-foot subs, and more. Brown's applauds every football player, coach, cheerleader, band member, and parent for your teamwork, commitment, and passion for the game. Come to Brown's in Loganville to celebrate the big win. Brownsorchards.com.
It's time again for York Mitsubishi's annual fall sales event with a great selection of 2016s in stock, saved like never before on all remaining Outlanders, Outlander Sports, Lancers, and Mirages. Rebates and discounts up to $4,000 or financing as low as 0% for 72 months. All cars are priced to sell, so now is the time. And as always, every new Mitsubishi gets our famous 10-year, 100,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. So stop by York Mitsubishi's annual fall sales event and see what we can do for you. York Mitsubishi, just off Route 30 on Roosevelt Avenue, York.
So you're dialing an 800 number to see if you can save money on car insurance. That's fine, but try asking where you're calling.
So anyway, where am I calling?
San Antonio, Texas.
Bahama.
Tuscaloosa, Alabama.
Why not call your local neighborhood Donegal agent instead? Donegal's auto insurance rates are routinely among the lowest in the state. And with Donegal, safe drivers save even more. Plus, by working with a local independent insurance agent, you get professional advice from someone you may already know. Save money on your auto insurance through your local Donegal agent. Donegal Mutual Insurance, there when it matters most. As an independent agent, Harry L. Bubb Associates is dedicated to helping you through every step of the insurance process. Bubb Insurance is conveniently located in Hanover, Shrewsbury, and Red Lion. Call or visit Harry L. Bubb Associates today.
Sports injury? Walk into WellSpan Urgent Orthopedics for immediate care. No appointment is ever needed. Our orthopedic and sports medicine specialists are here to treat you. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today for hours at our York and Hanover locations.
First in York, first in sports. Sports Radio 1350, WOIK.
And we're back at York Catholic. Ron Ruman and Gareth Hissong here as the Irish put a tattoo in on the Bermudian Springs Eagles tonight, 35-7. Want to thank Kevin Bankos, the new AD here, and Rick Luckman as well, and all the good folks, Gary Owen and everyone here. Bob Holman not here tonight, but I know Bob was thinking about us. So we want to thank everyone for the hospitality here, as always. Always good to come to York Catholic. It's the Irish win it tonight, 35-7. Our final stats from Coachman Kunkel Insurance. Now for Bermudian, they had a tough time all night, Gareth, getting it going. This is a team that came in averaging 262 yards a game on the ground. And Devin Hogden, who's been really on fire for them of late, 6 carries, 8 yards net tonight. Ashton West, 10 for 32. Brenton Krebs, 9 for 44. Most of those late in garbage time. Addison Wheeler, 8 for 55. And Chase Dahl, 1 for 7. So they ended up with 34 carries and 146 yards, but a lot of that really came after the issue was decided. Through the air tonight, they don't like to throw a lot. They were 4 of 13, 69 yards for Chase Dahl. Devin Hogden did have 2 catches for 21 yards, including a 17-yard touchdown. Trevor Hasulin climbed the ladder and made a great 37-yard catch while they were still in this game. And Ashton West had 1 catch for 11 yards, so 215 total yards for the Bermudian Springs Eagles tonight. For the Fighting Irish of York Catholic, it was a different story. Their offense was really, really rolling tonight. And here are some impressive numbers for you. The senior running back, Jakar Kennard, 30 carries, unofficially 272 yards, 4 touchdowns, including touchdown runs of 71, 39, and a couple of one-yarders. Quarterback Daniel Kemick, 14 carries, 83 yards. Kyle Dormer, 1 for minus 3. And Jordan Williams on the fake punt, 1 for 11. 46 carries, 363 yards on the ground for the Irish tonight. You know, Kemick through the air, 5 of 9, 72 yards, 1 touchdown pass. Riley Brennan, 2 catches for 20 yards, had a 15-yard touchdown reception. Brendan Kennedy, 2 for 44. Ryan Sewell, 1 for 9. And Carter Sinclair, 1 for minus 1. So the Irish, 435 total yards tonight. And those are your Cookman Kunkel final stats. The Irish beat Bermudian 35-7. Take a break, come back with our Sure Save Markets player of the game and our York Traditions Bank scoreboard show after this on the High School Football Game of the Week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine.
Get your football parties started with great Best Yet products from your neighborhood Sure Save Markets. Pick up party platters with $18.93 deli items. Team up Best Yet hot dogs with Best Yet kettle cooked chips. And get Best Yet 12 packs of soda and Best Yet rising crust pizzas at Sobel's Markets in Shrewsbury, Stewartstown, Whiteford, and coming soon to East York at Nell's Markets Fresh Food in Spry and East Berlin and at Wetzel's in Glenrock.
My name is Bob Innerst. I've been a York Traditions Bank customer since 2008. One of the things that I like about York Traditions Bank is that I know everyone is right here in the York area and everybody's local and the decisions are made, you know, right here at the bank. So I feel very comfortable if I need a loan or if I have a question about anything, I'm going to get the answer from the people right here. Because we live here too means that they share a lot of the same concerns that I do. I know that they give back to the local community, and it really makes a difference. They're invested here, and that's important to me. I now tend to measure other businesses that I deal with the level of service that I get at York Traditions Bank. I feel that York Traditions Bank never takes my business for granted. I highly recommend York Traditions Bank to anyone.
Transition to traditions today. York Traditions Bank, member FDIC, equal opportunity lender.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports.
All righty, we're back here at York Catholic as the home crowd filing out happy as the Irish win a big one tonight, 35-7 over Bermudian. Both teams came in 4-0 in the league and 6-1 overall, but the Irish take control of Division III. Now they have Fairfield and York Tech remaining. If they can win those two, they will be the Division III champs and also probably moved or helped to solidify their top spot in District III AA. They were a couple of hundred percentage points ahead of Newport coming into tonight's action. Let's get our Yorktown or our York Traditions post-game scoreboard show for you here. First of all, Littlestown and D3, they stay one game back of the Irish. York Catholic has defeated them at Littlestown tonight over Biglaville 33-14, and next week it'll be Littlestown and Bermudian. So the winner of that one will stay alive for the division race, then the loser will definitely drop out of it. Dallastown goes to 7-1, a 55-6 win over New Oxford. We'll be in Dallastown next week as Central comes to town. Make sure you join us for that one. Red Lion leading Central 28-18 in the fourth, so the Panthers hung in there, but got to assume Red Lion probably going to hang on there and go to 8-0. So Central next week will be playing for their district playoff lives. They will need to probably win their final two to have a shot at getting into the district playoffs, and we'll be heading for perhaps a Red Lion Dallastown showdown in week 10, and we'll have that one for you. DeLone defeats Fairfield 45-0 in Division 3. Eastern over Cannondale 26-6. Northeastern over Spring Grove 27-0, so the Bobcats go to 6-2, and the Rockets drop to 4-4. Susquehannock leading West York 28-21 in the fourth, as both of those teams looking for their second win of the year. Southwestern has defeated York High 28-13, and York Suburban leading Dover now 23-13 in the fourth. The Eagles hung in there, but if Suburban wins that, they'll go to 6-2 and remain undefeated in division play. So that's your York Traditions Bank post-game scoreboard show. Time now for our Sure Save Markets player of the game.
He's the senior at running back. Clocks in at 6 foot, 175 pounds. Number 2, Jakar Kennard. An impressive 30 carries for 272 yards and 4 touchdowns. Also did a lot on defense, breaking up passes, and the discipline to not let guys get over the coverage. And if he's a dynamic athlete, he has one catch coming into this game. If the Irish need to open up their offense, they just need to find a way to get him the ball, throw it to him out of the backfield, and watch out anyone that plays against them.
All right, so Jakar Kennard, our Sure Save Markets player of the game tonight, leading the York Catholic Fighting Irish to a big 35-7 win over the Bermudian Springs Eagles. Don't forget, tomorrow morning, 9 a.m., Wayne McCullough wraps it all up for you, all the Friday night action on Central PA Game Day, and next Friday night we'll be in Dallastown as the Central Panthers come to town. So again, that's going to do it for us. Our final tonight, York Catholic 35 and Bermudian Springs 7. For Lake Johnson on the video for Game Time, Jim Harden is always pushing all the right buttons back at the station. My partner, Gareth Hissel, I'm Ron Ruman. Thanks for listening, folks, and you have a good night.
Thank you for listening to WOIK